weekly matchups, injury reports, and sleepers.
Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly. Don't miss it.
In beautiful Vancouver, British Columbia, the two teams that entered the National Hockey League together, the Vancouver Canucks and the Buffalo Sabres, will do battle downtown Vancouver this evening. Hello, everybody. This is Rick Jenneret, along with Jim Lorenz. Dennis Williams will be along in just a moment. The Buffalo Sabres come into tonight's game still looking for their first victory in a very young season, and I suppose we should stress that. It's only two games into an 82 season so far. However, they are starting to rely already on the goaltender.
Well, of course, Dominik Hasek started the season on this road trip in Edmonton and really had a mediocre night. Mm-hmm. Then, of course, the team moved on to Calgary, and Dominik was much better against the Calgary Flames. He gave Buffalo a chance to tie the game, gave them a chance to win. But here tonight, he's going to be tested again against one of the better offensive teams in the NHL. And here's what Dominik had to say about the Vancouver Canucks.
Probably gonna be more shots this game, but you cannot think just about this. You know, there are two very good players like McGillney and Bure. They can score goals, and they are very good skaters, and so anytime they are on the ice, you must be very careful.
There might be more concern as far as the Sabres are concerned if they had not been getting scoring opportunities, but in Calgary, oh man, they had oodles, but they ran into Rick Tabarachi on a night that I have never seen Rick Tabarachi play as well as he did.
He was just brilliant, wasn't he? Yeah. And that's the last thing Buffalo needed was a hot goaltender, and Tabarachi gave that to the Calgary Flames. He frustrated Buffalo time and time again. A couple examples coming up. Buffalo really, I thought, controlled the game from the middle of the second period on into the third. Here's one save on LaFontaine. He makes three or four dandies on Patty Lala, and Buffalo just could not get anything by him. Look at this save. Watch the left glove. Tabarachi down on the ice. He spins around while he's down there and still comes up with it as LaFontaine has yet another scoring chance. So I guess the good news is, as you mentioned, yes, Buffalo, no, Buffalo's not scoring, but yes, they are getting the chances, and that's the important thing.
Well, I think to take that one step further, you might say, hey, don't change now, because you had things going the right way just because you couldn't beat a hot goaltender.
No, that's right. And I think from a coaching point of view, too, that's Ted Nolan was talking about accenting the positive, and that's what he means. Hey, guys, we played well against Calgary. We're getting good scoring chances. Just keep going the same way, keep working hard, and the puck's going to go into the net for you. So I think from Buffalo's point of view, they tried to keep everything positive. Yesterday, they practiced considerably on their offense, and they're just hoping that sooner or later they're going to get some breaks and the puck will go in.
But the Sabres are going to have to keep an eye on McGillney and Bure, right?
Oh, two of the most explosive players in the NHL. Alex McGillney, 107 points last year. All of us from Buffalo know what he's capable of. Pavel Bure played only 15 games last year, hurt his knee. Coach Tom Rennie said he's 100% physically, but still he's not there mentally yet. So he's still not sure how his knee's going to react in certain situations.
And from upstairs here at GM Place, let's go downstairs and find Dennis Williams.
Guys, along with what you're saying, the Sabres do believe they're going to have some scoring chances here tonight. The coaching staff believes that Vancouver's defense may be a little suspect, so they will get the opportunities. They just have to convert them tonight. Back upstairs to Rick and Jim.
One of only two meetings between these two teams this season, this to be played at GM Place in Vancouver. The other game, of course, will be back at the brand spanking new Marine Midland Arena in Buffalo as the Sabres wind up their Canadian Western Road swing tonight.
You said you'd never give up luxury car comfort. You said you wanted style and performance. You said you wanted something fun to drive. Well, now you can get all that plus a great deal. And guess what? It's a minivan, a Ford Windstar, actually. For a limited time, you can get $1,500 back on a new 96 Windstar, or choose a $279 a month red carpet lease. So what do you say now? Well, I'd say that this offer ends soon, so hurry to your local Ford dealer today.
So long, you almost get to thinking it's never gonna happen. Then one night we get this call.
Kaylee would be here in a little over a week. We had so much to do. I mean, we had the nursery, we had plane tickets, lawyers.
Anyway, suddenly we find ourselves at the airport.
She was just so beautiful. Somebody's hungry.
You should have heard her at the airport.
What is Pro Shop Buffalo Hardwood? They're do-it-yourself hardwood floors and floor care products. Western New York's largest and best place for original Pergo laminate floors. The largest selection of Carhartt rugged wear.
Buffalo Hardwood.
We'll show you how.
Is brought to you in part by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By Dodge, the new Dodge. See your team Dodge dealer today. And by Pepsi. Nothing else is a Pepsi. Back at the GM place, as we await the start of tonight's hockey game between the Buffalo Sabres and the Vancouver Canucks. After an absolutely gorgeous couple of days in Vancouver, Mr. Hasek getting his third straight start, and he will have so many more for Buffalo this year, sporting that goals against average of 3 coming into tonight's hockey game. Kirk McLean is seeing plenty of action for Vancouver, as Corey Hirsch is on the injured list right now, and the backup goaltender tonight is Mike Fountain, and we're going to have a little bit more to tell you about him. Suffice to say, he's got enough frequent flyer miles now to last him for quite a while, I think.
And he did it in the last 3 days.
I know he did. All right, we are ready to roll here in Vancouver as Hasek will take on McLean and Bill McCreary, the referee. The only time you see the referees face off anymore in the NHL.
The linesmen this evening, Mike Civic and Don Henderson, who have worked an earlier Buffalo game on this road swing.
Galley inside his own line. It's whipped out to center ice. Didn't get to Audette. Brought right back by Linda. Tips it into Gelinas, looking in front of the net. They shot, they score! Pounding in there right off the bat was Pure. And the Russian Rocket, 14 seconds into the game, gets free and chips one in behind Hashik. And the Canucks are on the board early.
Gary Galley commits himself. Watch Galley at the bottom of the screen right here. And that sets up a 2-on-2. But Bure simply beat his check on the far side and beats Dominik Hasek for his first goal of the season. Boy, that assignment was in the hands of Michael Groshek. His job was to stop Bure, and he couldn't do it.
And right off the bat, the Canucks surge into the lead. Shen now working it to Wilson. Wilson trying to move away. Back for Shannon again. Leaves it there to Mike Wilson. Up on the wing to Daw. He touch passes it down the ice. McLean must play it in behind the net. McGillney going charging in there. Rolls around to the other side. The Canucks getting an opportunity to work it out, but not getting it out. Kept in front of the net. Daw, the shot right on. And McLean foiled him. Hope back around on the boards again. Finally kicked out to center. Shannon had some difficulty, could not control it, tapped in over the line, Tikkanen fanned on it, gets another chance, and then has it stripped away by Shannon, but he can't get it out. Now it's fed to center ice, and it's fired right up into the crowd, and actually up into the Sabres bench area, and we end up getting a whistle there. Vic's deep discount stretches. Bob Buchner and Brad May not with the team. They started out the trip, of course, but both on the injured list. Semenoff and Virata are with the team, and as far as I know, healthy at this moment in time, but they are victims of numbers tonight. Corey Hurst, the goaltender, Brett Hedekin, Dana Merzen, defenseman, and Roberts and Scott Walker sitting out this for the Canucks.
You see Hedekin and Merzen, two of their better defensemen, and that's where they're vulnerable, this Vancouver club, and Buffalo must use their speed and quickness to get on the Vancouver defense and cause turnovers.
Now the Canucks trying to work it out. Lume sails it ahead to Quartnell. On the wing it comes to Ojic. Ojic wheels it in over the line, trying to clear it in front. That went too far for Lume. Lume managing to hold it in, though, slipping it back into the corner, and it's kept in there by Ridley. He tried to roll it behind the net. Schmelik takes him down. Ojic flips it, knocked to the blue line, not out. Quartnell keeping it in at the point. Let his shot go, deflected right on, rebound, another whack at it. And Hasek covers up and hangs on to that one.
Well, there was an example in front of the net. The Sabres did not play tough in Edmonton, did not play tough in Calgary, and here tonight they're not playing tough, as Ridley just stands in front of the net and gets a chance at this rebound. Now you've got to knock people down, and the Sabres don't do it. Hasek comes up with the puck, but a very poor play in front of the Buffalo net. Pavel Bure with his first goal of the season in regular season play this year. He had 5 in the preseason.
Jelena and Linden with the assists on the play at just 14 seconds. And it's kept in there by the Canucks again. Naslin stuffing it down low, rolls around behind the net, chasing after it. Canucks trying to work it out of there, poked around on the boards again. Fed free, but not out. Held in by Crowder. Galley couldn't catch up with it. That one bounces free and comes away to center ice. Holzinger ripping in over the line with Primo. Holzinger falling, trying to keep it in there. Trying to control it. Naslin will kick it free and start out. He comes to center. Slapped around behind the net by Selinger. That's poked around on the boards. Canucks, however, managing to keep it in as Crowder chases after it. Zhitnik breaks it up and finally got it to center, and Ray racing after it now. Ray charging in over the line. Watched by Babbage. Ray goes down. And behind the net, Primo trying to take out Babbage, but it's fed up ahead. And the Canucks will come back with both teams trying to engineer a change. Wilson catching up with it behind the net. Up on the wing it comes to Shannon. Cross ice pass. That misses everybody. Goes down the ice. The Canucks will get there first. It's claimed by Chris Joseph, and that'll be the icing against Buffalo.
Now Kirk McLean getting the start tonight for Vancouver, and there was some raised eyebrows when Coach Tom Rennie started McLean in the opening night here in Vancouver. McLean did not have a good last season, did not have a good preseason,
Corey Hirsch was expected to get the start because of his terrific play in the preseason. Tom Rennie said last year was an off year for McClain. And he said, I know that he's going to rebound, and so far he has.
McClain went through a difficult divorce situation last year. By the way, I even say difficult. Oh, obviously. The shot off the boards now, not out. The Canucks holding it in, and it ends up bobbling its way out to center. Joseph taps it right back in. Shannon is there to cover up. 3 minutes into the opening period. Vancouver on top early. Pass ahead to LaFontaine. LaFontaine chipped it in over the line as he bounces off Rolin. Joseph behind the net. Cleared it up along the boards. And it ends up bouncing over the glass and out of play. 1-0. The Canucks have the lead on Pavel Bure's marker.
Throughout life, you're faced with a lot of important choices, and finding the right car is no exception. Luckily, the Cavalier from Chevrolet is there to make it easier, with choices that offer affordability for the value conscious, space for those who prefer to travel in a group, performance for those who demand it, and freedom for those who need a little breathing room. The Chevy Cavalier. So many choices, so much car.
16s in the faceoff area way down there. Linden and LaFontaine. The captains get set to do their thing outside the Vancouver line. Kicking away at it, Audette takes it away and to Shannon. Shannon will launch one in off the seamless glass and around behind the net. McClain got checked. Here's LaFontaine trying to stuff it out in front. Audette, he tried to fire it off the goaltender. That didn't work out. Dead after it again, bouncing in there along with the referee. Groshek pries it free, and he's got to dodge the referee. Back in the corner, Groshek keeping it in to LaFontaine, trying to twist away in the corner to Audette. Audette takes a bump from Linden. Linden, down on the board, Shannon will hold it in. Linden's got it again behind the net. As Groshek got knocked down, the pass going up ahead to Zelenov. Zelenov working it over to Bure again, broken up by Shannon. Zelenov catches up with it. Jelena working it down low. Linden in the corner behind the goal to Bure. Bure looking out in front. Here's Bure, cleared it out in front, taken away by Groshek. Groshek starting out with LaFontaine and up on the wing to Wilson. Wilson trying to cut in over the line, can't do it. Vancouver coming back as the Sabres make a change. Whistled up ahead, fired into Buffalo territory to Bure, and Shannon strips him of the puck. Another pass taken by Plant. He whipped it through center. That deflects down the ice. Plane is scooping in behind the net for McGildy. McGildy having some difficulty getting away, bothered in the corner by Plant. And behind the net. Oh, got it right out in the goal crease. It's right in the line. They score! That one going off of Burridge's body. And the officials are going to try and talk this one over now. But the Sabres, at least for the moment, have tied the hockey game.
Well, I think Bill McCreary is going to go upstairs and have a look at this. He signaled it was okay, that it was a goal. But Vancouver automatically began to argue. But this was caused by good forechecking. Remember we were talking about the quickness of Buffalo? Look at the flat-footed Vancouver defense. The puck bounces to the front of the net, and Burridge has it go in the net off his body. McClain waves it off. No goal, he says. Here's another angle. The puck bounces up in the air off the stick of McClain. And it looked like the right hand of Burridge may have directed the puck into the net.
Unless it went off his glove and then off his other part of his body, right? Or his stick, yes. I don't think there's any doubt about it that he did play it with his glove. That much is a given. But we'll wait until McCreary sorts it out. And again, McCreary did not wave the goal off. And neither did the goal judge. Of course, the goal judge's job is to turn the light on as soon as he sees the puck cross the line.
Sure.
That's right. He did his job.
So the play is under review.
No goal.
No goal.
And so it is not going to count, as they're saying, we assume that the puck was directed into the net by the glove of Randy Burridge. Now watch the puck bounces off the stick of McLean. Watch the right hand of Randy Burridge right there. He certainly plays it off his hand.
And apparently it went off the glove and into the net, so there will be no goal. The Canucks still leading 1-0. Approaching the 5-minute point of the first period here in Vancouver. Whipped around on the board. Cullimore trying to get it out of there. Schmelik will hustle back after him. McGillney's right on him. They bump, goes behind the net. Burridge gets knocked off stride. Cleared it up on the wing to Plant. Plant took a whack at it, didn't get it out of there. McKee in the corner being bothered by taking it. Now Plant comes over to give his check a bump. Kept in to Lume, who's pinched in from the point. Back again, knocked down finally, and whipped up on the wing behind Daw. Daw trying to get there, but Cullimore beats him to it. McGillney will leave it. Back comes C-Mac in over the line. He drops it back, taking in the long shot. Has it to save the rebound. Oh, and McGillney almost chipped that one in. Daw starts away. Could not get it to Pekka. Broken up right at the line. Daw coming back. He'll just feed it off into the Vancouver zone. It rolls behind the net. And as Babbage picks it up, that will end up being an icing call against Buffalo.
So what we're seeing here in this early going in the first period, we played less than 6 minutes, is lots of scoring chances for both teams. Thought it was interesting yesterday. Head coach Ted Nolan took his club to an eight-ring compound just outside of Edmonton. And the Vancouver Canucks were practicing to the right of us, the Sabres to the left. Ted Nolan's hockey club was all offensive practice, moving the puck, attacking. And the Vancouver Canucks, Tom Rennie, was all defensive on the other ring.
Should have scrimmaged the two. So they should have.
Had a great time.
Canucks keeping it in now, but intercepted in front of the net and fed up on the wing. Now the pass back through the middle again. That'll be whipped in by Brown. Plain wants to play it and does around on the glass. Ward kicking at it. He gets knocked off his pins. Ojic attempting to get away. Got it to Courtnell at center. Courtnell can wheel. And he runs into Galley as he fires it in. Hasek chips it up along the boards. Cross ice pass intercepted. Courtnell keeping it in there. Zitnik takes it away. He lost it. Came back to the point to Babbage. A shot going wide of the net. Zitnik letting it slide free, and the Sabres finally gaining possession. Ward just gets rid of it through center ice. Whipped back in the other direction to Ridley. Ridley faked his shot. He drops it to the trailer. Courtnell. Hasek no difficulty with that. Galley strips it away the puck. Tips it out to center ice where Rolin covers up. Fed right back again. Wilson hustles after it. Wilson whipping it up on the wing. Pass coming away to center to Brown. He tried to get it to Lafontaine, who went down. And there'll be a penalty coming up here to Vancouver. The Sabres will go on the power play when we come back, trailing 1-0 here in the first period.
Could be amazing.
No, that's gonna take more than a little work. How much are you asking?
The money part is all taken care of.
Oh?
I'm just looking for somebody to do the work.
I thought so.
Dad. Daddy.
Well, Pat LaFontaine is trying to skate his way into the zone, and at the top of the screen, right up here, you'll see Chris Joseph will pull down LaFontaine as the play continues, or as the puck goes into the Vancouver zone. 2 minutes for interference, and that is the first penalty of the hockey game. Buffalo on the power play.
7:06 the time here in the opening period. Buffalo needing the power play goal to tie this one up after Bure scored in the opening seconds of the game. Galley slips it ahead, but it's up on the wing. Now sent away to LaFontaine at center to Audette. Audette in over the line looking for LaFontaine, but it's going to be called on the offside. The pass was about 2 feet above LaFontaine's head anyway. There's Chris Joseph in the penalty box, and boy, the Canucks are one of the most dangerous teams in the NHL when they are shorthanded. And they put players like Courtnell on the ice, Jelena, who's out there now, along with Trevor Linden. They're always looking to score that shorthanded goal. And their best scorer shorthanded is Courtnell, who had 4 goals and 2 assists while his team was a man short last year to tie with Mario Lemieux for the league lead.
Schmelik will try it now. Leading the rush as far as center, he tips it in, took a bump and got hammered by Jelena behind the play, and the Canucks managed to send it back down the ice. Galley picking it off now, swings it back to Schmelik again. He'll try and bring it out of his own end. Makes a nice move to get rid of Jelena, now to LaFontaine and over the line. LaFontaine trying to cut in, the one-hand shot went around behind the net. Fontaine to Galley, in along the board for Audette. Back to Galley again, over to Schmelik, one-timer, he missed it. Came right through the goal crease. Fired a shot by Audette, went off LaFontaine and just wide. By Schmelik and back down the ice. Buffalo with the man advantage here, approaching the halfway point of the opening period. And away goes Galley. He steers it ahead. It's brought in over the line. Holzinger to LaFontaine. Tipped it off into the corner. Plant can't catch up with it in time. Kept in by LaFontaine, though. Then his pass goes astray and out to center ice where Zitnik has to cover up. Zitnik whipping it ahead. That missed Holzinger. Went around behind the net. He charges after it. But Babich gets there first, and that's going to be an icing against Buffalo.
I think Babich has been one of the better defenseman for 17 seasons in the NHL. Last year here in Vancouver, he played his 1,000th NHL game. They had a big ceremony for him. They gave him a boat, and then all his teammates skated onto the ice with mustaches that they had pasted on. Of course, that has been his trademark for many years, but you talk about one of the truly nice guys in professional sport. Dave Babich goes right to the top of the list.
Keegan comes out to try and kill off the remainder of this penalty. 19 seconds left in the penalty to the Canucks. Ends up being stuffed back in by Burridge. Now to the corner. Fontaine will leave it there. Eric Plant striding away for Buffalo. Bure keeps an eye on him. Plant, he likes to hammer it in. Holzinger racing in there. He gets knocked down. Burridge fell. He just tumbled into the boards by himself. Canucks coming up with the puck, and a long pass to Joseph coming out of the penalty box goes down the ice. Whipped ahead to Holzinger. Oh, and his pass was nowhere near anybody. This is going to be another icing against Buffalo. That wasn't even close.
Well, the faceoff will be back to the right of Dominic Hasek. I'm talking to Tom Rennie yesterday after practice. We were asking about putting Alexander Mogilny and Pavel Bure on the same line. He said, well, he said, I've thought about it, believe me, but he's like putting all your eggs in one basket. He said, I really want to spread the scoring around if possible so that the opposition will not be able to key on any specific line. So what he's done is really come up with two excellent hard skating lines. And I'm sure from time to time, though, you will see Bure and Mogilny on the same line.
Pekka whipping it out to center ice. Ward stepping in over the line. Shannon backhand hit the goal post. Rebound right on by Brown. And the Canucks will bring it back out. Crowder flipping it in. Hasek deals that around on the boards. Pass going to Pekka. Cross ice to Brown. Cutting in on goal. Brown shoots one. Right on rebound. And McLean manages to keep that one out of there. Kept in by Buffalo again. Try to slide it in around. Ward took a pounding in the corner. Now Pekka unable to come up with the puck, and the Canucks get it back. Shannon flags that one down at center. Giving it to Wilson. He whips it across to Pekka. Pekka will sail it in on his way to the bench. Oh, there's an interference against Ray. That wasn't called. There's a long shot. Ray couldn't catch up with it. went around behind the net again. Ray cleared it in front, but McGillney knocks it away to Jelena. Jelena in over the line to Linden. Back to Jelena again, looking for Bure. Schmelik breaks it up to Ray. Ray starting back with a pass on the wing to Primo, but he couldn't catch up to that one. And they'll bring it back down the ice on another icing call against Buffalo.
Well, as we suspected, Buffalo getting their opportunities to score against Vancouver. The Canucks, a very good offensive team, but not good back of the blue line. And the Sabres, I think their game plan, dump and chase, dump and chase. Here's an opportunity by Darryl Shannon, who had followed up on the play. Watch the goalpost to the right of McLean as the puck glanced off the post. Curtis Brown had an opportunity. But give McLean credit, after the puck had glanced off the post, he got himself in position to make the save on the rebound to Curtis Brown.
Schmelik bothered behind the net by Jelena, who's all over him. LaFontaine helps out, and that'll end up at center ice. Just 9 minutes remaining here in this opening period. Vancouver, Canucks in front by one. Cullimore squeezed it ahead, taken back by McKee. He tried to get it to LaFontaine. It was bumped down by Lume. Pass whipped up to Cullimore. He just gave it away to Schmelik. Bothered by Bure, Schmelik got away from him. Uses the boards. Ripped out to center ice. LaFontaine coming away with Groshek. LaFontaine to Groshek, and he couldn't pick it out of the air. Jelena coming back to Bure. Bure whips in over the line. Bure kind of feed it in front. Here's Jelena. Didn't get any wood on it, though, as he was tied up by McKee. Deflected through center. This goes down the ice. Oh, come on. You can't call that one. I seen the Vancouver player try to play it and missed it. In any event, they don't call it because the Sabres got there first. Up it comes now to Tiikkanen at center. Tiikkanen in over the line. Trying to get it back to Bure. Galley had an eye on it. Set around on the boards. Burridge trying to shovel it out of there. Does. Runs into the referee. It ends up coming out over the blue line. Plant cannot get away, and C-Mac has it. He'll drop it back in. Galley picks it off. C-Mac going right through the goal crease. Off the glass, out to center ice. Passing the other way. Plant gets in over the line. He got hacked by Joseph. Around behind the net. Fired off the glass again. Ends up all the way back in the Buffalo end, where Shitnik claims the puck. Shitnik whipping it to Burridge. Burridge bumped by Tiikkanen. It came out over the line. Buffalo getting it back again, but very scrambly at the moment. Tiikkanen leaving it there to Rolin. Up it comes to Tiikkanen again. He just got rid of it. So did Galley in the other direction. Stripped away by Daw, feeding it in over the line. Ward whipped it off behind the net, goes after it again, but gets knocked down. Rolin. He tries to come away. Tapped up on the boards through center ice again, brought to the Buffalo line. McGillney couldn't get free. Tiikkanen still out there. Here's Curtis Brown, across ice pass. That's picked off, brought back in by Courtnell. Trying to feed it in front. Shannon takes it away to Ward. Ward out to Pekka. Pekka in over the Vancouver line by himself. Back to Ward again. It's kept in neatly by Wilson to Pekka. He chips it over to Ward. Good shot. Way wide. Wilson moves up trying to hold it in. Courtnell takes it away. Courtnell got rid of it through center. Went behind Ogic. Pekka in the other direction. Runs into Cullimore. Over 6 minutes remaining in the period. Ends up at center ice. Brown after it again. He gets checked. The Canucks will get another opportunity to Ridley. Shannon takes that one away. Buffalo coming back with a pass up on the wing. In over the line is Ray, looking for the trailer. Got it to the other side. They shove it off. McLean kicking that one away. And they're hanging on to the rebound. 1-0. The Canucks have the lead here in the first.
And now from Paris. From Milan. From St. Louis.
Introducing a new look from Budweiser. Born on dating. It's the day your bud was born, because fresh beer tastes better.
Nice label.
Thanks.
If you're having debt problems, we can help. We're Consumer Credit Counseling Service of Buffalo.
Your credit counseling program's the best thing that ever happened to us. You taught us how to budget. And next month, we're buying our first home.
Our counseling is free and confidential. We're here to help. Call 854-1710.
Linden and LaFontaine are in the face-off circle just to the right of the Canuck goaltender, Kirk McLean. 6 minutes remaining in the opening period. Tip to the boards. Groshek tried to leave it there. LaFontaine got knocked down, and it's picked up and taken away to Jelena. Jelena will sweep it in. Ure trying to catch up with it. Wilson got there first, but Jelena comes up with it in the corner, whipped it right onto Wilson's stick. His pass didn't get anywhere. Finally chopped out to center. Audette couldn't come up with it. Then he knocked down his check, and it's taken away by Shannon. Up the middle to Audette. That's picked off. Head for Jelena again. Shannon took him out of the play. Wilson in the corner. There's Linden right behind him. Around to Groshek. He'll tap it to the blue line and out. Audette leaving it there to LaFontaine. LaFontaine in over the line, going to his backhand, leaving it. Groshek couldn't get it. Shannon does. LaFontaine lost his stick. LaFontaine behind the net, looking out in front. Leaves it there to Schmelik. Didn't get a shot away. Jelena picks it up and starts back one-on-one. Jelena, allowing his teammates to change, brought it back in over the line to Bure. He got turned around, but a shot is off a leg. Kept in by the Canucks, right to the goal crease. And then Hasek had the company of Jelena in his crease. Slipped up ahead. Burridge gets cut off by Joseph. Taken away by Rolin, and an interference penalty coming up to Chris Joseph here.
Throughout life, you're faced with a lot of important choices, and finding the right car is no exception. Luckily, the Cavalier from Chevrolet is there to make it easier, with choices that offer affordability for the value conscious, space for those who prefer to travel in a group, performance for those who demand it, and freedom for those who need a little breathing room. The Chevy Cavalier. So many choices, so much car.
The joint's always jumping. Friday, October 18th, Marine Midland Arena, Buffalo. One night only. Come see the sizzle as the Toronto Raptors take on Alonzo Mourning and the Miami Heat in the Molson preseason shootout. Catch Damon Sotomayor, Marcus Camby, and all the Toronto Raptors entertainment. Tickets start at just $15 at the box office or by calling 716-888-4000 or 888-223-6000 now. Because the joint's always jumping.
Chris Joseph takes his second interference penalty of the period. Here's why. Watch Burridge attempting to get to that loose puck into the corner, and Joseph rubs him out along the boards. That's interference, a good call by the referee McCreary, and the Sabres have their second power play.
That will feature Plant, Burridge, and Daw up front. Shipnick and Schmelik. Buffalo's had oodles of scoring opportunities, but unable. Now it came in front again, and that one is fired away at the last second. Schmelik back to pick it off.
Yeah, actually, the Sabres have had more scoring chances than Vancouver. The Canucks just one scoring chance, 14 seconds into the game, and they scored.
Plant with a pass ahead for Daw. Didn't get anywhere. Shipnick keeping it in. Shipnick feeds it into Daw again. Daw behind the net, trying to tip it around to Plant. Got it out in front, and Burridge couldn't connect. Now the Canucks coming back. McGillney chasing after it, took his shot, and Hasek was well prepared for that one. Derek Plant away through center to the Vancouver line. Swings it in over the line to Audette, looking in front of the net. It didn't get that far to LaFontaine. Back comes Ridley. Ridley with Babich. Ridley is denied. He likes to go back to center ice to take time off the clock. A minute left in the Canucks penalty. Courtnell just rips it away. Zhitnik will slide back after it now. Alexei Zhitnik looking for the open man, likes to carry it himself. Now to Groshek. Groshek in over the line, going wide, getting around Ridley, sending it back to the point to Galli, to LaFontaine. That deflected just wide of the post.
Held in there to Audette again. He lost control. Phillips cleared the zone. Shipnick pulls away from Cortnell. Here's Shipnick, muscles his way around Babich. Shipnick whips it into the corner. Shipnick sending it back now. Kelly to Shipnick. Shipnick twisting around in the corner, cuts in front of the shot. McLean makes the save. Babich can't get it out. Groshek's all over him. Audette gives it to Shipnick. Back to the point it comes. Galley, the long shot. That one's tipped off the glass. And Babbage fires it off the boards and down the ice. And the Canucks are back at full strength. Shipnick getting rid of it in his own zone. Galley back to Shipnick again. Sabres are trying to complete a change here. It's tapped down the ice. Racing after it in the corner is Brown. He's going to be called on the offside. Won't be an icing call. He got there first, but they will rule it on the offside. Many other games being played around the National Hockey League on this particular night, although this one, because it's on the West Coast, is the latest one. And the Ottawa Senators have trailed by as many as 2 goals in that game, but they're down by only 1 at this point in time. Montreal having a little difficulty with the Los Angeles Kings. Detroit, I can't say the same against the Edmonton Oilers, who are a vastly improved hockey club this year. And in Chicago, the Blackhawks are trailing the mighty Ducks of, well, St. Louis has the 2-0 lead over Calgary.
Well, the Buffalo Sabres on that most recent power play, only 1 shot on goal. They did have some scoring chances. Went wide. And they're certainly, again, harassing the Vancouver defense, and that's one of the keys, as far as I'm concerned, for Buffalo tonight, is to get on the Canuck defense and cause turnovers.
Pekka squeezes the puck out to center. He got around Rolin, but Linden covered up on the play. That'll be whipped back across ice for Bure. Edmund must have been hit with a high stick, I've got a feeling. I don't think it was an offside. So Faceoff will come back inside the Vancouver line.
Pavel Bure scored 14 seconds into tonight's game. One of his typical goals, just using his speed to get into position to score a goal. And as you can see by that statistic, he knows how to find the net. Back-to-back 60-goal seasons. And Tom Rennie was saying this morning to me, he said, Pavel is 100% physically, but he said not mentally. He said he still doesn't trust his knee in certain situations, and he said that's to be expected. It's going to take him some time.
Shannon will tip it ahead, but that'll be picked off. It's Wilson who whips it right back in again, almost took off Rolin's head. McLean coming out to play it away, cleared to the blue line. Shannon held it in. Canucks get a chance, though. Linden out to center to Bure. He ducked away from a check, and it's chipped in by Pekka. Less than 2 minutes remaining on the clock here in this opening period. Ward fighting for it on the board. Squirts free to Linden. Linden will whip it off a skate. And the Canucks maintain possession with a cross-ice pass to Joseph. Joseph working it ahead to the blue line. Shannon got a skate on that. Jelena into Bure. And Wilson took it away from him. Up the boards, out to center ice. Buffalo coming back 2-on-2. Holzinger in over the line, fires one. That goes off the glass, over the head of the goaltender, and out of play. Not necessarily in that order anyway. Trevor Linden will be Dennis Williams' guest between the first and second periods. Sabres assistant Paul Terry will be along. We'll be back to chip in as well. 1:11 left on the clock here in this opening period at General Motors Place in Vancouver.
Brian Holzinger at center between Primo on the left and Rob Ray on the right wing. Primo is normally a centerman, getting an opportunity to play his first game of the season and parked on left wing.
Ray getting all tangled up with Ogic. Ogic tapping it behind the net. Ray steals it away, trying to jam it out in front. Rebound! And it's tipped just wide. Great opportunity by Holzinger. Back come the Canucks again. Cortnell got it in over the line. Schmelik picks it off. Schmelik leading the rush away. Schmelik got away from Cortnell, comes to center, 3-on-3. He whipped his shot right on. McLean knocked it free. Schmelik trying to carry on. Sabres hold it in there. Primo pries it free in the corner. Primo being bothered by Ridley. Got it in front of the shot. That just went wide as Holzinger spun around. McKee pinching in to keep it in there. Fed off the boards, an awful leg to center. Ray knocking it down. For Jay McKee trying to whip it ahead, but Lume takes it back. Buffalo making a quick change. 20 seconds left in the period.
Ume took the shot on the goalpost. No, but it has it, lost it completely. It bounced up in the air, it hit the post, but it did not cross the goal line. Holy mackerel.
I think Dominic Hasek was already thinking what he was going to do when he caught this puck and lost his concentration. No idea where it is, and the puck just fails to bounce over the goal line and into the net. So a mental lapse by Hasek. Hard to tell whether the shot may have been deflected, but still, Hasek must come up with that long shot and got away with it that time.
He stole one there. 13 seconds remain on the board.
Well, the faceoff, LaFontaine will take the draw against Tikkanen. Now, LaFontaine has been very good on faceoff so far this year.
Waiting for the linesman Civic to drop it. Come on, Mike. Anytime you're ready. I got a plane to catch, pal. Drop the puck.
Tikkanen will talk him to death. He never shuts up, Isa.
Well, you can talk to him after the game. I don't care about that. Drop the puck now.
Hearing enough of him, threw him out there.
Kept in, a long shot from the point, just deflected wide. Hasek flopped on that to cover up again with 8 seconds to go.
Now Tikkanen gets thrown out of the faceoff circle, and the Canucks win it cleanly. Boy, Hasek was lucky on that one, too, as that puck came in and deflected in front of the Buffalo net just wide of the corner. LaFontaine loses this one clean. And the puck bounced up, might have been LaFontaine, and just wide of the net, so another close call.
Well, this time C-Mac will take it against LaFontaine. Early drop. LaFontaine winning that one. It goes around behind the net. Recovered by Galli off the glass to the blue line. Held in there. Here it is in front again. Galli took out his kick. The set went into the net, but the whistle had already gone, I believe. And the period has come to an end.
Well, let's wait a minute. The Canucks are congratulating one another, saying they had scored. The Sabres are just as adamant that they did not score. And that the period comes to an end, with the Canucks getting one very early and threatening to get one very late. But it is going to be no goal at the end of the period. Vancouver will have the 1-0 lead.
Well, here's that opportunity as the puck is lost in front of the net, shot into the net by Vancouver, but the red light did not go on, and the time has expired. The red light cannot go on. It is no goal. It remains Vancouver 1 and the Buffalo Sabres no score.
And that goal coming only 14 seconds into the game.
Your local Jeep and Eagle dealer.
Lots and lots, tons and tons of tennis balls. Some of the things that are on my Discover card statement. I travel quite a bit. Ooh, I didn't know that the golf balls were on here. Just relax, enjoy nature, and very good. Labidochromis coeruleus. They don't want to play with me now because I beat them 90% of the time. I'll take out $100 to buy the bait, gas up the boat.
How many credit cards make a statement like that?
See, what else do I have on this?
It pays to Discover. Use it where you see the notice sign.
Bold, tastefully done. Critics are raving about Three the Grown-Up Way. From Mickey D's, producer of the critically acclaimed Arch Deluxe, comes three new deluxe sandwiches.
Crispy Chicken Deluxe.
Grilled Chicken Deluxe.
Fish Filet Deluxe.
And that's an order.
Yes, sir.
Mature taste. Love toppings like whole leaves of lettuce, juicy tomato, tasty sauces, and a fish filet that's 50% bigger.
You're going down.
Three the Grown-Up Way. An exciting new part of McDonald's lineup.
I'm going in.
Going in with you.
If you're having debt problems, we can help. We're Consumer Credit Counseling Service of Buffalo.
Your credit counseling program's the best thing that ever happened to us. You taught us how to budget. And next month, we're buying our first home.
Our counseling is free and confidential. We're here to help. Call 854-1710.
Welcome back to Buffalo Sabres Hockey on the Empire Sports Network, where the score after one period of play, Vancouver on a goal 14 seconds into the hockey game leads the Buffalo Sabres by a score of 1-0. Well, I'm with now the Iron Man, the Cal Ripken of the National Hockey League, Trevor Linden, who's played in 458 consecutive NHL hockey games. He's also the captain of the Vancouver Canucks. How do you do it? How do you play in so many games and stay injury-free, knock on wood?
Well, I just think it's a situation where every player in the National League wants to play every game, and I've been fortunate. I think a lot of it has to do with your body makeup and what you're made of. Obviously, different players are more susceptible to injuries, and a great training staff. But as far as Cal Ripken, I got a long ways to catch him.
Yeah, it'll be a little tough in the National Hockey League to catch that record. How about this team this year? How do you guys shape up in the Western Conference?
Well, last year we definitely were an underachieving team, and with Tom Rennie coming in, a new coach, and hopefully a new attitude and some better systems and this sort of thing, hopefully we can play better. We've got the talent, we've got the ability. It's a matter of putting our ability to work on the ice, and so far we're doing not a bad job of that.
You've got some guys on this team who have had a real taste of success, and you got to be hungry to want to get back to the finals again.
Oh, for sure. We've got a good, great core of guys. I mean, we've got the scoring ability. We've got great 1-2 punch and goal. Defense is all about playing defense, and it doesn't matter who you are. You have to play in your own end, and if we can get a commitment to that, we can go a long way.
What does Tom Rennie bring to this hockey club in his first year as your head coach?
Well, he's just brought a great attitude. He's got such an upbeat personality, and he expects hard work, and he's got some great ideas, great thoughts. He runs great practices, and I think half of winning is attitude, and we want to change that around.
Thanks so much for taking the time with us.
Thanks
very much. All right. Well, Buffalo Sabres hockey will continue on the Empire Sports Network. When the score after one period, Sabres are trailing Vancouver 1-0.
Throughout life, you're faced with a lot of important choices, and finding the right car is no exception. Luckily, the Cavalier from Chevrolet is there to make it easier. With choices that offer affordability for the value conscious, space for those who prefer to travel in a group, performance for those who demand it, and freedom for those who need a little breathing room. The Chevy Cavalier. So many choices, so much car.
You cheating heart will make you weep. You cry. Try and try to sleep, but sleep won't come. Your beating heart will tell on you.
What is Pro Shop Buffalo Hardwood? They're do-it-yourself hardwood floors and floor care products. Western New York's largest and best place for original Pergo laminate floors. The largest selection of Carhartt rugged wear.
Buffalo Hardwood.
We'll show you how.
Hey, come here. You, come here. You want to play fantasy football with the pros? Then watch Fantasy Football Weekly.
Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly delivers the inside scoop. Our experts focus on every facet of football, analyzing key weekly matchups, injury reports, and sleepers.
Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly. Don't miss it.
Welcome back to GM Place in Vancouver, British Columbia, where the score after one period of hockey here in Vancouver, the Buffalo Sabres trail the Canucks by a score of 1-0. An exciting first period. Buffalo Sabres were not outplayed in that first period by any stretch of the imagination. They were the victim of a goal 14 seconds into the game by Pavel Bure. There are your shots on goal. A very, very even matchup there. The Sabres out shooting the Canucks 8-7 power plays. The Sabres had two of them. They were 0-2. As for scoring chances, the Sabres had a bunch of them. They had five against the Canucks 3. Sabres hockey continues on the Empire Sports Network. We'll be back in just a moment. Vancouver leads Buffalo 1-0 after one period.
And now, from Paris, from Milan, from St. Louis.
Introducing a new look from Budweiser, Born on Dating. It's the day your bud was born, because fresh beer tastes better.
Nice label.
Thanks.
You said you'd never give up luxury car comfort. You said you wanted style and performance. You said you wanted something fun to drive. Well, now you can get all that plus a great deal. And guess what? It's a minivan, a Ford Windstar, actually. For a limited time, you can get $1,500 back on a new 96 Windstar, or choose a $279 a month red carpet lease. So what do you say now? Well, I'd say that this offer ends soon, so hurry to your local Ford dealer today.
To really get inside the NFL, there's some equipment you'll need. Introducing Topps NFL Cyber Cards. All the action, all the plays, all the stats, all on a CD-ROM. Each Cyber Card features a different NFL star, and there's 28 different Cyber Cards to collect. So for the hardest hitting lift you've ever seen, it's Cyber Card. As close as you can get to the game without getting dirty.
To order with American Express, MasterCard, or Visa, call 1-800-341-7755 or send check or money order to the address on the screen.
Canucks on the scoreboard and in front of Buffalo after one period of play here at the GM Place. Apparently the Canucks started to play a little sooner than the Sabres did, like 14 seconds earlier than the Sabres did.
Well, they sure did, didn't they? Didn't take Vancouver long to get on the board, but gee, I thought Buffalo really played actually a better period than Vancouver.
Yeah.
The Canucks did not have that many scoring chances, which was one of the Buffalo game plans, was to cut down on the shots and scoring chances. But Pavel Bure's a great player, and one of the things that he possesses, of course, is that great speed, getting himself in a position to score a goal, and that's what he does in this goal that we're going to have coming up here.
We're going to take a look at it now and find out just how Bure got free and was able to score there in the first period.
Well, you're going to see the play develop up through the neutral zone. If we can just keep it rolling from there, guys, we want to see Gary Galley come into the picture. And you're going to see Galley is going to, there he is at the bottom of the screen. Now watch what Galley does here. Even though he commits himself toward the puck carrier right here in this position. Now we've got Galley right here. Now Pat LaFontaine does the right thing by shifting over and taking Galley's position. But watch what happens from there. Watch on the left of the screen. Now you're going to see LaFontaine's in good position. And if we can stop it again, this is Michael Groshek right up here. And he lets Pavel Bure go. And Bure, of course, all he needs is a step or two to get himself in a position. That's what he does and scores a goal. But Mike Groshek, it was his job to turn around and make sure that Bure didn't get to the front of the net, and Michael Groshek did not do that.
Well, we can take a look at the scoring summary for Discover Card, and it certainly indicates that the Buffalo Sabres and the Vancouver Canucks were relatively close in that first period, only one shot on goal separating the two teams, but Bure had the only goal, and it came, too early for Dominik Hasek and the Buffalo Sabres. Jelena and Linden gaining the assists on the play.
Thank you.
local Jeep and Eagle dealer.
Hi, this is Larry Playfair. Avoid traffic and confusion. Take the Metro Rail to the Sabres home opener, and between 4:30 and 6:30, meet members of the Buffalo Sabres alumni at the South Campus Station.
Catch Sportsline with Paul McGuire, Tuesdays at 6:30 on Empire Sports Network.
If you've been thinking about pursuing a career in sports, or upgrading your current education for promotion, or maybe you've been thinking about a career change, then you should think about the Masters of Science in Sport Administration program at Canisius College. One of only four programs of its kind in the country, the Sport Administration program has formed affiliations with major professional sports organizations across the country. And with our highly experienced and qualified faculty, the Masters of Science in Sport Administration at Canisius College is the one program in Western New York for you. Call now for more information.
Come on, show me your new smile. Oh, I see. We're all grown up now. Pretty soon, it'll be boyfriends, tuition, a wedding.
No, sorry, just kidding.
I suppose pretty soon you'll be needing a car.
Really?
Really? That's a smile.
Dad.
Oh, that was a smile. I think we can take a check. Check, please.
Sabres Hockey is brought to you in part by your local Chevrolet Geo dealers. Cars you can trust from people you can depend on. By Pepsi. Nothing else is a Pepsi. By Buffalo Hardwood, your Carhartt rugged wear outlet. And by Topps Friendly Markets. Topps never stops saving you more. Vancouver Canucks holding a 1-0 lead as we await. Well, we first of all have to await the arrival of the Canucks on the ice because they're not out there yet. The Sabres have been out for the last, minute or so. The officials are out, but no sign of the Vancouver Hockey Club.
And I was talking to Donald at depth this morning. Donald was saying how happy he was that his knee didn't act up on him after that performance the other night in Calgary. And Pat LaFontaine, of course, very happy to have Donald back on the hockey club and on his line. And when Donald Adep gets himself into condition, you're going to see that line produce a lot of goals for Buffalo.
Well, the Sabres actually did have a goal in that first period, but it was ruled incorrectly, as we saw the replay, that Randy Burridge had knocked it in with his glove. And actually, Burridge didn't even complain about it. He knew darn well that when they went upstairs and looked at it, they were going to find that he indeed had done that. I think he tried to knock it from his glove onto his stick, but he wasn't able to do that.
Now, Lee is being also pushed toward the goaltender, and the puck went into the net. Of course, the Canucks immediately yelled for go upstairs for a review. Pavel Bure, the goal scorer tonight, 14 seconds into the opening period. I was talking to members of the media here, and they say Pavel doesn't talk too much, sort of a withdrawn individual. But they said since Alexander McGillney has come here to Vancouver, Pavel has sort of opened up, which really? I was surprised to hear.
No, because Alex really didn't spend that much time talking to the media.
No, he did not. But apparently he does here. Here's a look at Alex. I was talking to him the other morning after practice, and he was very interested in what was going on in Buffalo and asking how everything was. So I'm sure part of his heart still remains in Western New York, although he's played very well here for Vancouver. Incidentally, Alex lives in Washington State, which is not far from Vancouver, just over the border, but does not live in Canada.
Delaney's moved since last year then, right?
Yes,
he was living north of Vancouver last year.
We understand that he does want to become a U.S. citizen, so perhaps that's one of the reasons he's living over there.
Zhitnik will now fling it down the ice, but it's going to go wide of the net. LaFontaine got there first, trying to get it in front to Audette. Oshik holding it in. Oshik to Audette in the corner, spinning away from one, got it out in front. LaFontaine was taken down. Canucks will bring it back again. Fed over on the wing to Linden. Linden trying to work his way in on goal, but Hasek is there to take it away. LaFontaine hacks at it. Doesn't get it out of the zone, however. Fights off a check, dribbles it in the other direction. Babich keeping it in. To Bure. In front of the net, Jelinek gets checked and it goes to center. Coyne backhands it in. Zhitnik knocks it down and pulls away from Jelinek. Zhitnik rolling into Vancouver territory, tried to clear it back. That's broken up. And away to center ice. Jelinek starting back. Jelinek in over the line. Didn't get his shot away, and Plant has it. Plant feeds it to Shannon. pick it up in his skates off Daw into the corner. Joseph there first. Joseph bumping with Plantel on the boards. Daw keeps it in. Oh, and he gave it away to Bure. Bure coming right back again with Zelenov. Bure in over the line. Take his shot. Got it in front of the net. And the net is not flying now as Wilson went right into hashing.
Well, Mike Wilson lost his balance, and lucky for Buffalo as he flew into the net, knocked the net off the magnets just when the Canucks were about to get a scoring chance. But Mike Wilson paired with the veteran Darryl Shannon, and how many times have we seen that? I remember Jim Schoenfeld when he broke into the NHL. Larry Hillman, of course, the veteran, had a lot to do with developing Jim Schoenfeld's career, as did the late, great Tim Horton. But here's the play as Wilson tries to get back and check Jelinek, loses his balance, and knocks the net off the magnets.
Say nothing of the goaltender off his pins. Plant jamming it into the corner. Wilson knocks it away to Daw. And he got it as far as center. Burridge picks it off, coming with Plant. Burridge in over the line, looking for Daw. The shot scores! Jason Daw was all tied up, but fought off the check of Leif Rolin and hammered it home, and the Sabres have tied it up early here in the second.
This play develops at the Vancouver blue line, and I made this point back in the first period. Look at the bad pinch by the Canuck defense. They get caught in an outnumbered situation, and the Buffalo Sabres, Jason Daw, fights off his check and scores a great goal, his first of the season, using his speed and quickness, and the Buffalo Sabres have tied it on a play that began back at the Buffalo blue line.
So the Canucks score early in the first, and the Sabres early here in the second. Pekka will feed one in now. Lume going back after it. Lume in the corner, got squeezed out by Ward. Rolled back to Schmelik, but got away from him and went to center ice to Kortno. Kortno with Ojic. Kortno took the shot. Hasek kicked that away. Bounces into the circle. Hedekin flipped it wide. Round behind the net. Not out. Kept in there to Ridley. He feeds it in front. Lume going right in. Oh, and Hasek scrolls and makes the save. Ridley keeping it in for Vancouver. To Kortno again. Kortno looking for an open man. Schmelik ties him up. Ojic picks it off. He'll send it down low. Hasek out to play it around on the boards, but not out. Lume keeps it in. Made the prices. Ward took it away from him. Ward muscles it out to center. Brown hustling in over the line. So is Kortno. Brown knocked him off his feet, and Kortno's all upset about that one. Away to center ice. Canucks coming back with Ridley. Ridley in over the line. That's an offside, however, as it was Marcus Naslund who got in there too early. Burridge and Wilson getting the assists on Jason's Daw. Jason Daw's, I beg your pardon, first goal of the year in his second game.
Chris Cardinal is from Duncan, British Columbia, and his wife is Paris Vaughn, who is the daughter of the legendary jazz singer Sarah Vaughn.
Broken-hearted melody.
I know,
get the idea, folks.
You have her complete set of jazz records, I know that. Bring them along with you on the road.
Jidnik leaving it there to Galley. Tried to get it to Holzinger, couldn't control the puck. O'Coin now to Crowder. Crowder tips it ahead. That's recovered. Ray slipping it across ice. Primo zipped it out of the zone. O'Coin to Crowder. He'll flip it back in. Sillinger after it. Jidnik there ahead of him. Jidnik trying to get away and does with a pass up the middle to Holzinger. Holzinger coming away now. He gets in over the line, gets squeezed out, but it's kept in there, cleared out in front. Crowder picking it off. Crowder coming back with O'Coin. Here's Troy Crowder looking in front of the net, cleared it in front. And it's deflected wide. Kept in now by the Canucks again, fired across ice. And then an errant pass by Crowder goes all the way through center. And Crowder and Ray are mixing it up in behind the play and are still mixing it up. Oh, it's dumped back in over the line. There's going to be a penalty coming up here. And it's going to go to Ray. He got caught retaliating. So Ray will enter the penalty box. The Canucks going on the power play. This game tied at one.
Freshness Hotline, what's the problem?
Man, my party is lame. I think I got some skunky beer.
Sir, relax. When was your beer born?
Born? What are you talking about?
It doesn't have a born-on date?
A what?
Do you have any Budweiser?
No, man, you gotta help me.
Okay, remain calm, sir. We're on our way.
New Born on Dating from Budweiser. Because fresh beer tastes better.
Go!
Sir, put down the skunky beer and slowly back away.
An opportunity to view the Vancouver power play as Rob Ray is in the penalty box. 2 minutes for roughing as he retaliated against Troy Crowder.
Back to the point, Bure, he'll hold it in, tipping it to the corner, and it's kicked by Shannon through center. LaFontaine charging in over the line, backhand right on. McClain made the save, and LaFontaine doing some high sticking with Joseph. Moving back into the Buffalo end, Shannon took out his check. Pecker ran into his man. Around behind the net. Canucks trying to set it up to McGillney. He deals it back to Joseph. Over to Bure. To Joseph again. Joseph fires the shot in on goal. That's kicked away by Hasek. McGillney keeping it in there. A minute and a half left in the Buffalo penalty. To Joseph once more. Fires it off into the corner. Linden knocks it down. And he is bumped by Shannon. McGillney keeping it in to Jelinek. Jelinek to Linden to McGillney. McGillney wheeling it back to Bure. Bure loaded a shot in front, but it's intercepted, and Shannon hammers it down the ice. Sabres do some changing, and the Canucks as well. Pass going around to Linden, bothered by Daw. McGillney doesn't get it out. Here's Clapp keeping it in, taking a shot. And that goes off Bure up into souvenir country.
You know, I was talking to Dominic Hasek this morning about facing the big shooters on Vancouver, namely Alexander McGillney, and I asked Dominic, what are you looking for when Alex has the puck? And he says about 80% of the time he's found that Alexander McGillney tries to go through the five hole. And Dominic says he doesn't shoot the puck that high. He usually shoots the puck low. And he says, as far as Pavel Bure is concerned, he said, I don't know, I haven't faced him that much, but he said, I have a... In watching him and from what I've seen, he says Pavel Bure is more apt to be more spectacular and put the moves on you than an Alexander McGillney.
Courtville would like to put some moves on now, but he's checked by Daw. Daw will take it away from him and clip it around behind the Vancouver net with 38 seconds remaining in the power play for the Canucks. Daw trying to keep it in there, bothered by a coin from behind. Sent around to Lume. He squeezes it ahead to Tikkanen. Long shot off the corner glass. O'Coin hustling in there. Went behind the net. Galley broke it up to Schmelik. Schmelik flips it to the blue line. Knocked down, but Plant knocked it away to center. Lume. Behind his own net. Getting away from Plant and leading the rush now for the Canucks. Lume fires it over to Tikkanen. Covered by Galley. It's chopped off the boards. The Sabres will get a chance to get it out. And can't do it. Kept in with Tikkanen's shot. Hasek to Schmelik. Schmelik using the boards. O'Coin knocking it down at center ice. Full strength again. Schmelik lost it in his own end, but it's going to be called here. And there's been a penalty called on the play. This date in Sabres history brought to you by Rosina Italian Sausages and Meatballs. Buffalo won their season opener in 75 over Detroit. Eight straight wins for the Sabres. Well, that won't happen this year, obviously, as they've lost their first two already.
Now, the referee went to the penalty box, and I don't know whether he's called the penalty or what has happened, but the Canucks are reluctant to put players on the ice. It's Bill McCurry, the referee tonight, and he is, yes, indeed, signaling to the Vancouver bench.
Are they calling for too many men on the ice?
Possibly.
Maybe, because Tom Rennie is obviously putting up an argument, and he's not sending anybody over, and he's testing the patience now of the referee McCreary.
Well, I can see why Tom Rennie was practicing defense yesterday. The Vancouver defense, as we mentioned at the beginning of tonight's game, very slow. They're not tough, and they don't have much mobility. And that is evident tonight. They have made some very poor decisions at the Buffalo blue line, and trying to pinch in. Tom Rennie's hockey club is getting caught in odd man rushes by Buffalo. The Sabres, Jason Daw tying the score. And Buffalo now on the power play.
Reiner being served by Naslund. Sabres' third power play opportunity. The first two fell short. Away goes Galley. Galley working it up to Zhitnik. He steps in over the line, trying to leave it to LaFontaine into Zhitnik along the boards. Zhitnik's got room, sending it back to Galley. He feeds it into Zhitnik again, pulling away to LaFontaine. LaFontaine for Galley. Galley spreading them out, gives it to LaFontaine. Back it comes to Galley. He fires one. That goes by rebound, and Odette couldn't pick it up off the backboard. Canucks smack it down the ice.
Well, Mike Groshek is doing a great job in front of the goaltender Kirk McLean in getting good position, and that means the Buffalo defenseman must shoot the puck when Groshek is standing there screening the goaltender.
Zhitnik's turn once again to tip it up on the wing now. In over the line, and a shot deflects. Groshek let it go, poked into the corner. Groshek then chopped off his feet. The Canucks will take their time, and Babich just easing it down the ice once again. Less than a minute to go on the power play for Buffalo. 1-1 here in the second period at GM Place in Vancouver. Schmelly got away from his check. Ridley. Well, then he gave it right back to Ridley. Brought in over the line. And it's Lube who sends it to center ice. Galley whipping it over to Schmelly. They'll give it to Gary Galley to try and set it up again to Burridge. Over it comes to Schmelly. Pass behind him. Going to pick it up at center ice, but the Canucks break it up again. They're taken away by Plant. Could not control it. And it ends up being flipped down the ice. Galley to pick it off back there. 20 seconds left in the power play. Gary Galley looking for LaFontaine, who darts into the corner after it. LaFontaine tried to squeeze it behind the net, but it's chopped around on the boards. Schmelly keeping it in there. That flipped free, and the Canucks will recover now, using the glass to send it down the ice. And Naslund about ready to step back on, and does. So Vancouver, I mean, not too much problem there, killing off that minor penalty. McKee, he tips it ahead. That's going to miss everybody, and this will be coming back on an icing call with just a tad over 12 minutes remaining in the second place at GM Place, and it's 1-1 in the second.
Lots and lots, tons and tons of tennis balls. Some of the things that are on my Discover card statement. I travel quite a bit. Ooh, I didn't know that the golf balls were on here. Just relax, enjoy nature, and very good. Labidochromis coeruleus. They don't want to play with me now because I beat them 90% of the time. I'll take out $100 to buy the bait, gas up the boat.
How many credit cards make a statement like that?
See, what else do I have on
it
this?
It pays to Discover. Use it where you see the Nova sign.
Bold, tasteful, and done. Critics are raving about Three the Grown-Up Way. From Mickey D's, producer of the critically acclaimed Arch Deluxe, comes three new deluxe sandwiches.
Crispy chicken deluxe.
Grilled chicken deluxe.
Fish filet deluxe.
And that's an order.
Yes, sir.
Mature taste. Love toppings like whole leaves of lettuce, juicy tomatoes, tasty sauces, and a fish filet that's 50% bigger.
You're going down.
Three the Grown-Up Way. An exciting new part of McDonald's lineup.
I'm going in.
Going in with you.
Vancouver early in the first, Buffalo early in the second. Sabres single game seats for games at Marine Midland Arena now on sale. Available at all fantastic outlets in Topps Friendly Markets and at the Sabres ticket office. On the faceoff now, Brown trying to work it out of his own end, does by getting it to center. Bure collecting it back there. O'Koy whipped it to Selinger. Oh, and Pekka almost stole it away. Now it comes to center ice. Vancouver covering up again. That's fired ahead and misses everybody going down the ice. Wilson trying to get there and uses that extra long reach, but apparently didn't touch it in time. Shannon stacks back. Shannon squeezes his way through the middle and tips it in. Ward hustling in, but the plane is out to roll it around for Jelena. Jelena ducking away from Ward's check. Ward digs after it, got it in front. Shot right beside the net. Kept in again. Comes back to the point. Shannon knocks it down and rips it wide. Back it comes to Shannon again. Another shot. He gunned it over top of the net. Canucks recovering and will bring it out by tipping it up to Selinger. He got wiped out but got it into Fury. And Fury, there's going to be a penalty coming up here to Buffalo, but I'll tell you what.
Fury, on another night, would have won an Oscar. He might have gone down, but he made sure he was going to get a penalty drawn against him.
I believe Curtis Brown would agree with your assessment. He was saying, hey, Mr. McCreary, I had good position on Burry, and he took a dive. And look at Brown. He is in good position. And Burry did take a dive, but he's a veteran. Curtis Brown is a rookie, and the rookie goes to the penalty box. And a good job by Burry.
That's something to do with the law of the jungle, doesn't it?
I think so. Yeah. So the Canucks will enjoy their second power play of the evening with a face-off to the right of Dominik Hasek. You can notice the speed and quickness of Curtis Brown in that play, though, as he caught up to Burry quickly. Brown is a very smooth player who has got great hands around the net, and I think is going to be an excellent professional.
Ojek is out on the power play with Linden and McGillney.
You know what his job is? Stand in front of the net. Ojek is 6'4", 225 pounds.
He'll have to wait before he stands in front of it because Shannon backhands it down the ice. Taken by Joseph, bothered from behind. He finally kicks it up on the wing. McGillney stacks away. He rolls in over the line, trying to clear it in front of the net. Brown broke it up. Shannon off the boards, but not out. Canucks keeping it into Ojek. He'll poke it down low, hit the referee in the corner, comes back to Bure. He works it to the other side. The shot by Joseph goes wide of the net. Bure keeping it in there. Ojek, he got checked, then got it back again. Around it goes to Linden. Back to Curtis Joseph. Joseph keeping it in. Joseph's got it again. He whipped another shot. That one just grazed the goalpost. I don't think Hasek saw it. Linden keeping it into Joseph. Joseph fires it into McGillney. Cleared it in front. Hasek falls and hangs on as it was Ojek who was kept in front of him.
And but Dominik Hasek knew exactly what Alex McGillney was going to do in that play. McGillney hesitated for an instant. And as soon as he hesitated, Hasek knew that the play was coming to the front of the net. Now watch Ojek. Just in front, and Hasek is ready for the shot. As Ojek, give him credit, he did a good job as spinning away from Mike Wilson, getting himself into position for this scoring chance. And that's the problem when you have those big guys standing in front. They get position on you, use their body, get their stick on the ice, and Hasek beat Ojek on a nice pass from McGillney.
A little over a minute remaining in the Brown penalty. Almost halfway through regulation time in this game. Kept in by Joseph again. He'll dump it off to Linden. Back it goes to Joseph, and the shot kicked away and picked off by LaFontaine. LaFontaine through the middle to Zitnik, coming with LaFontaine again. Into LaFontaine! And called on the offside. The Buffalo captain was slowed down by the opposition right at the blue line.
That was an exciting rush by the Buffalo Sabres, led by Alex Zitnik. LaFontaine, as Rick mentioned, just could not break loose from his check. I was talking to Zitnik yesterday after practice and was asking Alex if he planned to maybe change his game this year, and he got pretty passionate. He doesn't usually get excited, but he said yes. He said, I realize, he said, I can't do it all myself. And he wanted to start utilizing other players on the ice, not carry the puck so much. And we've seen a difference in Zitnik's play so far in this young season.
Tiekkanen out on the ice for the Canucks. We still have the man advantage and will for another 51 seconds. O'Coin waiting around back there. He's on one point, Lume on the other. O'Coin got it up the middle to Lume, to Kortnell. Kortnell swinging in. His shot misses on the short side. Tiekkanen holding it in. It's tipped back into the corner. Cleared but not out. O'Coin keeping it in. O'Coin feeding it into Kortnell again. Kortnell works it into the corner, came in front of the net, knocked down, and it's chipped out and knocked down the ice. O'Coin after it, and Pekka watching him. Now work to Lume. Buffalo changing, back to Kortnell. Kortnell swings it into Jelinek with his shot. That's kicked away, the rebound. Hasek cut off the angle there, and it's fired out to center ice. But 10 seconds remaining in the penalty. Lume drifting one across as his teammates are changing. Babich just jams it back into the corner, broken up by Zitnik. Trying to leave it there to Plant. That went off a skate. Buffalo returning to full strength. A high shot off the glass. Tiekkanen keeping it in. Rolled it back to the point. Stolen away. Sabres starting away with Brown. Brown to the Vancouver line and over. And he gets checked at the defense by Babich. It's worked out to center ice. Jelinek starting away. Jelinek took a bump from McKee. Pashek hooking it around to Galley. Galley stops in the corner, sliding it around to Jay McKee once again. He'll leave it back there to Galley. 8.5 left in the second period. 1-1. McKee to Galley. He got it up as far as center. Ray trying to go after it. Got tripped up. Taken back by the Canucks. Cullimore feeding it ahead. Now in over the line comes Ridley. Ridley swung it in front. And Hasek was there to handle that one. It was deflected right on, but he watched the puck all the way right into his glove and holds on to it long enough to force a face-off coming up in the Buffalo end. Vancouver and Buffalo are all even at one, just past the halfway mark.
We have a wonderful 75 Lacroix Cabernet, or an exquisite 58 Le Bourg-Semillon, or a 62 Jevaux Pinot, if you're in the mood for...
No. Enough of that old stuff. The lady and I would prefer something fresh.
How about something in a lager? What do you got in a Budweiser from, say, early this month?
Budweiser. Guaranteed fresh with born-on dates.
For Caravan, we invented new ways to stash your stuff. Now we're building more bins and boxes and a great new place to put them. The new Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises. We packed our full-size Ram with Magnum Power. Now, we're reloading. The new Magnum Power Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises.
Now, I'd have a little problem getting a get-up like that on,
well,
I think. But
I thought he was related to you somehow.
Well, the Sabres have yet to play a home game, but they are going to against Detroit on Saturday night. You'll see it on Empire and on Channel 4. In Buffalo, Saturday night at 7:30. Shannon rolling it up along the wall. Poke to the blue line, not out. Now it'll come out to Wilson. Wilson trying to squeeze it ahead, broke it up. McGillney brought it back in, called on the offside. Right at the Sabres blue line.
One of the players making a comeback for Edmonton this year, number seven, or for Vancouver, number 17, Mike Ridley. He was bothered with a serious back problem last year. Had an operation in California, and the Vancouver people were telling me this year he did a great job of rehabilitating himself, came back and found that he was fatiguing, his legs were getting tired, and he saw Trevor Linden one day working out in the weight room on his legs, and just says a light went off and said, gee, maybe that's something I should try. And so he's been working hard with the weights on his legs, and apparently he doesn't have the problem anymore.
Yeah, getting his legs hacked out from under him by Ridley. Brought in over the line to McKinley. The shot, and he fired that one off the glass. All the way to center onto Mike Groshek's stick. Groshek took a bump from Ogic. McLean whipping it around on the board. Finally tapped away, and it comes to center ice. Joseph bringing it back. Joseph went over the line to Ridley. Groshek got an arm on that one and guides it right over the glass and out of play.
That's one of the few attacks tonight that the Sabres have been outnumbered. Dominik Hasek stopped that shot with the blocker, deflected it over the glass, but this was a 4-on-2 break for the Vancouver Canucks. The Sabres have been doing a pretty good job tonight in their own zone in containing the Vancouver Canucks. But on that particular rush, the Canucks had four players up front. 16 saves for the Dominator tonight. First shot on goal went in. That by Burry at the 14-second mark. But Jason Dawes tied it here in the second for Buffalo.
Canucks holding it in on the faceoff. Cullimore's shot. Hasek saw that one all the way. Burry gets knocked down. Almost lost his helmet as well. They jam in on the boards. Back into the corner. Zitnik got it away. Zitnik doesn't get it out, though. Now Plant will get a chance, and he completes the job. Back in the other direction. Anybody hacking at the puck. Finally, Daw, who has the lone Buffalo goal, hooked it to center ice. Kortko works it across ice. Plant came very close to stealing that one away. Now Zitnik. He got it in over the line. Burridge got slowed down by Cullimore. Lume just getting rid of it. Off galley stick. Zitnik covering up for his defenseman. He rolls all the way back behind the net with less than 7 minutes remaining in the second period. Zitnik's got it again. Dealing it across to Galley. He helped it out to center where Lume takes it back. Blumen flipping it up on the wing, stolen away, and Platt got knocked down. Blumen starting back to Courtnell. He feeds it off into the corner. Sillinger started after it, now heads to the bench. Long pass up on the wing, Galley knocked it inside Vancouver territory, allowing his team to change. Babich tipping it away. O'Coin got rid of it to center, and it jumps and slides down the ice where Schmelik recovers. 6 minutes remaining here in the second period in Vancouver. Brown rattles one out to center, taken back by Babich. He whips it up to Linden. Linden forces it by one. Batted in over the line. Galley got a piece of it, didn't get it out. Galley's been out there a long time, but he's on the wrong side of the ice to get to the bench. Here's Bure keeping it in for Vancouver. Whipping it back to Babich, the long shot, and Pashek saw that one coming, saw Linden coming, and said, I think I'll hang on to this for just a moment. And other games around the National Hockey League tonight on the NOCO Express Shop scoreboard. Ottawa and the Islanders tied. Montreal doubled up on the Los Angeles Kings. Detroit defended Shanahan, I believe, in the lineup. 1-2-0. Anaheim over Chicago 2-0. And the only other game still going on, Calgary trailing at home to St. Louis 2-1.
The shots here in Vancouver show the Canucks with 10 here in the second, Buffalo with 3, but not as misleading because the Canucks have not had that many quality scoring chances.
Ray whipping it up at center to Schmelik. Schmelik getting it over the line, trying to get away from McGillney. He's behind the net, leaving it to Primo. Primo back for Schmelik again, bothered by McGillney. And it's tipped to the blue line. McKee keeps it in. Now it's fired out to center, and the Canucks trying to get an opportunity here. In over the line, Seabach with a shot. Hasek to save. Whipped ahead to Primo. Primo bothered by McGillney from behind. And goes down back at center ice. Canucks recovering. 5 minutes remaining in the period. Taken away by Primo. Pass over to Schmelik. Schmelik flipped it off Tikkanen back through the middle again. Ray got grabbed by C-Mac, and C-Mac got away with that. Up it goes to Courtnell. Courtnell winds up, takes his shot. He misses. Ojic keeping it in. Left in behind the net. McKee stops it back into the corner for Platt. Platt bothered by Ojic, but managed to muscle it out to center in any event. Lume recovering. He can't get anywhere. Here's Ridley. And over the line, it comes to Ojic. Hasek comes out, makes the save. Here back into the corner. Platt picks it off. Platt doesn't get it out, though. Canucks keeping it in. That's plugged in, and Josh goes by the net. And Ojic's backhand, but the play has been called, as it was gloved from one Canuck to another. Close enough. 1-1 here with 4 minutes remaining in the second period from Vancouver on Empire.
Bold, tastefully done. Critics are raving about Three the Grown-Up Way. From Mickey D's, producer of the critically acclaimed Arch Deluxe, comes three new deluxe sandwiches.
Crispy chicken deluxe.
Grilled chicken deluxe.
Fish filet deluxe.
And that's an order.
Yes, sir.
Mature taste. Love toppings like whole leaves of lettuce, juicy tomato, tasty sauces, and a fish filet that's 50% bigger.
You're going down.
Three the Grown-Up Way. An exciting new part of McDonald's lineup.
I'm going in.
Going in with you. I whack the weeds. So you want to know what's on my Discover card statement. I'm a camp cook and a bad one, but I've got a good stove. And he loves to chase that. The cash back bonus award.
It all folds up into a carry.
She loves to get flowers, and I love to give them.
How many credit cards make a statement like that?
Well, the toughest thing about buying a wetsuit is trying them on.
It pays to Discover. Use it where you see the Nova sign.
Some of the folks sitting in one of the many private boxes here in GM Place enjoying the proceedings tonight with a little over 4 minutes to go here in the second period. Shannon ducking away from his check. Linden wheels it up on the wing, but too far for Groshek. That'll be tracked down by Lume. He feeds it away, and the pass goes to Trevor Linden again. Up to Bure. Bure guides in over the line. Bure waiting for the trailer. Still with the puck. Wilson keeping an eye on it. Bure still got it. Took his shot. Knocked down. And it's fired away and tipped right back by Shannon down the ice. No icing there. Groshek watching his check. But it's dealt over on the wing by Jason Cullimore. Out to center. Groshek takes it back. Shannon works it to Haddad, who'll just crank it in. Jerky Lume rolling back after it. Buffalo trying to make a change. Linden stacks away. Linden hits the Buffalo line. Wilson stepped in front of him. Off the boards, but Linden keeps it in there. That's broken up. Ward coming back again. Here's Ward in over the line with Brown. Ward to Brown. The shot in the goal. Breaking right off the pipe. Buffalo holding it in. Back into the corner again. Brown's after it again. He overskates the puck. Fed around to the board. Zipnik taking a long shot. McLean kicked that away. Galley keeps it in there. Galley hooks it back into the corner. Brown tried to get it to Ward. He couldn't pick it off. And away goes Linden. Linden away to center ice. He gets knocked down. Ward getting it back. Ward back through the middle to the Vancouver line. Stopping. Well, electing to shoot. It went wide. Brown keeping it in there for Buffalo. Brown steered it behind the net. Sillinger coming off the bench. Flips it. Nod out. Sabres keeping it in. That deflects to the corner. Going after it is Brown again. Bumping with O'Coyne. Brown still kicking at the puck. Finally, Sillinger knocks it free and gets rid of it to center. Zipnik across for Galley. Galley right up by Tikkanen, and it's whipped out to center ice. Brought back in with Mogilny. Mogilny took his shot, and Hasek makes the stop. Mogilny fathered behind the net. Zipnik's all over him. Mogilny and Zipnik fighting for the puck. Mogilny still got it and then gave it away. Galley working it up now to Zipnik at center for Furridge. He'll chip it in. That went around behind the net. Joseph got it on the boards. Plant keeping it in there. Plant hanging on to the puck. Tipped in front of the net. Daw, the shot right on. And McLean making the save. Daw looking for his second of the night. Gilly misses it in the corner with a minute and a half left on the clock. Tapped around behind the Vancouver net to Tikkanen. Tikkanen fired at the center. Here's Mogilny getting away from Smellick. Mogilny going right in the shot, and Hasek makes the save and squeezes the pads together. Well, Mogilny tried to use his winger, but Hasek was not about to be fooled.
Now, let's think back. Dominic Hasek telling me this morning that Mogilny likes to try for the five hole. I think if Alex had this to do over again, he may pass the puck to the left. But there's the opening between the legs. Hasek gives it to Mogilny and takes it away from him. So a nice piece of goaltending by Dominic Hasek to outsmart Alexander Mogilny.
And just a little over a minute left on the clock now here in the second period in a pretty rapid-paced hockey game. I think folks back east are saying, thank goodness. Got to get up and work in the morning, right? Groshek on the boards. He gets jammed. It squirts free. Got another chance, but he doesn't get it out. Lume keeping it in. That's deflected right beside the net. They poke at it again. Ocek took a whack at it. Keeping it in there. Now they slide it around the boards. Ocek and Smellick all tangled up. Covered by McKee. He gets tied up from behind. Then he grabs his check. Here's Ocek turning in the corner. Vancouver's turn to put the pressure on, but Fontaine breaks it up. Cullimore tips it back at center ice. Groshek with an errant pass. And it goes to Courtnell. Courtnell wheeling in over the line. Kick free. Here's Ocek. The shot. Got a piece of that. Groshek feeding it into the corner. Smellick catching up with the puck. He just got rid of it to center ice where Lume knocks it down. To Ridley. Cross ice it goes down to Jelena. He fired one. That's right on. They might have hit Hasek in the mask. I'm not too sure. He got him up high in any event. He shakes it off as the Sabres are going to be called here for icing with 14 and a half seconds remaining in the period. The Sabres Fall 96-97 merchandise catalog is now available. Choose from the largest selection of Sabres merchandise in the area. Call 716-855-4140 or if you're outside the Buffalo area, 1-888 Go Sabre for your free catalog. Rob Ray will be talking to Dennis Williams in the second intermission. Sabres GM John Muckler along, and we shall return. Just like a general. Right?
Like who?
The general.
The general?
When he left the Philippines?
I shall return.
Yes, yes.
And he did.
He did so, and we shall so. MacArthur. General MacArthur. That's right.
I think he had a haircut like you did, too, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, well, very, very military, as somebody said to me. Linden and Plant on this draw. Buffalo recovering with about a dozen seconds remaining in the period. Not out, however. Shannon got tied up in there. And Linden got checked. Plant got it to the blue line, and it ends up sliding to center ice. Broken up. Linden coming back, but time runs out before he can convert. And as a result, the second period has come to a close here at GM Place. The Vancouver Canucks getting on the board very early in the first period, after only 14 seconds, as a matter of fact. But the Sabres coming back early in the second to tie it up.
And it was Jason Daw who beat goaltender Kirk McLean, but not a bad period for the Sabres, although I thought toward the middle of that second period they got a little bit loose in their defensive zone coverage, and the Canucks ended up with some good scoring chances.
So at the end of two, the Buffalo Sabres and Vancouver Canucks are all even, as the Sabres will wrap up their Western Road swing tonight on Empire.
Looking for the best? Then this could be the best news of the year, because you've never seen a better deal than $2,000 cash back on a new 96 Ford Taurus. For a limited time, your participating Ford dealers are offering $2,000 back when you buy or red carpet lease a 96 Taurus, which makes right now the best time for you to get one. So hurry to your participating local Ford dealer today.
I'm back!
That's right, folks, he's back. Thurman Thomas returns to the Empire Sports Network Thursday night, 6:30.
The joint's always jumping. Friday, October 18th, Marine Midland Arena, Buffalo. One night only. Come see the sizzle as the Toronto Raptors take on Alonzo Mourning and the Miami Heat in the Molson preseason shootout. Catch Damon Sotomayor, Marcus Camby, and all the Toronto Raptors entertainment. Tickets start at just $15 at the box office or by calling 716-888-4000 or 888-223-6000 now. Because the joint's always jumping.
Come on, show me a new smile. Oh, I see. We're all grown up now. Pretty soon, it'll be boyfriends, tuition, a wedding.
No, sorry, just kidding.
I suppose pretty soon you'll be needing a car.
Really?
Really. That's a smile.
Dad.
Oh, that was a smile. I think we can take the check. Check, please.
Weekend spills, the weekend thrills. NASCAR's top guns are telling Eli all about it. Hang on, because this week in NASCAR is coming at you.
Welcome back to Buffalo Sabres Hockey on the Empire Sports Network, where the score after two periods of play, the game is tied at one. Sabres and Canucks. Jason Daw's goal early in the second period tied this game at one. And now for our McDonald's Deluxe interview, I'm joined by Rob Ray. Rob, what'd you think of the second period and how the team played?
Well, I think the second period we come out a little scrambly. The first period, probably the first 5 minutes we're, running around a little bit, and then we got a little sound stable, and we worked their end pretty well. And this period we kind of got away from it. We were turning away, we weren't finishing our checks, and turning away from the puck instead of going after it.
One of the things tonight that you guys have concentrated on, it seems to have worked, is the forechecking. It's a little better tonight.
Yeah, before, I think the first two games we were a little hesitant on what we were doing or maybe who was going and we practiced on it the last couple of days, and I think tonight it's, probably the first game out of the three that it's really starting to work.
Rob, talk about your line. You're playing with a youngster, Wayne Primeau. How are things going out there for you tonight?
Well, it's good. These guys are coming out here. Zinger was here last year, and he played pretty well, and Primes is coming out and trying to crack the lineup and everything, and I think he's playing well. He's doing sound stable. He's going up and down his wing. He's playing well. And, first period, any luck at all, we probably could have had a couple.
Rob, what do you expect out of yourself this year? Personally, what are your goals?
It's something that I'm going to be playing in fourth line. Usually, the way it goes with probably younger guys. So I'm going to have to try to help them out as defensively as much as possible and just try to keep them positive. And, not getting away from what my role actually is on the team, going out and trying to look after things and standing up for my players.
Obviously, you still got a third period ahead of you, but are you looking forward to that home opener on Saturday?
Well, definitely, but that's a long time away right now. We're still looking for our first win, and hopefully we can get that tonight.
How important is it to get at least a point out of here and not go home 0-3?
Oh, we're not going to be happy with a point. We want 2 points here tonight, but, I think the chance is there to take the game, and if we can go out and, just get our heads back together here and get our game plan back going, that there's no reason why we can't take this game.
All right, thank you very much. Rob Ray, our McDonald's Deluxe interview. the burger with the grown-up taste. Buffalo Sabres hockey continues on the Empire Sports Network, where the score after two periods, Sabres 1, Canucks 1.
If you're having debt problems, we can help. We're Consumer Credit Counseling Service of Buffalo.
Your credit counseling program's the best thing that ever happened to us. You taught us how to budget. And next month, we're buying our first home.
Our counseling is free and confidential. We're here to help. Call 854-1710.
Bold. Tastefully done. Critics are raving about Three the Grown-Up Way. From Mickey D's, producer of the critically acclaimed Arch Deluxe, comes three new deluxe sandwiches.
Crispy Chicken Deluxe.
Grilled Chicken Deluxe.
Fish Filet Deluxe.
And that's an order.
Yes, sir.
Mature taste. Love toppings like whole leaves of lettuce, juicy tomato, tasty sauces, and a fish filet that's 50% bigger.
You're going down.
Three, the grown-up way. An exciting new part of McDonald's lineup.
Going in.
Going in with you.
What is Pro Shop Buffalo Hardwood? They're do-it-yourself hardwood floors and floor care products. Western New York's largest and best place for original pergo laminate floors. The largest selection of Carhartt rugged wear.
Buffalo Hardwood.
We'll show you how.
Hey, come here. You, come here. You want to play fantasy football with the pros? Then watch Fantasy Football Weekly.
Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly delivers the inside scoop. Our experts focus on every facet of football, analyzing key weekly matchups, injury reports, and sleepers.
Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly. Don't miss it.
We've played two periods of hockey at GM Place here in Vancouver, and the score after two periods, Sabres 1, Canucks 1. I am joined now by General Manager John Muckler of the Buffalo Sabres. John, what do you think about the way the team is playing tonight?
Well, I think this is our best game of the three that we've played at West. In the first period, I thought that after the first 4 or 5 minutes that we took command of the period, Dominic wasn't really sharp in the first period, but it's nice to see him come back in the second period. And he's a great competitor, and he came on strong. And late in the second period, or maybe around the 10-minute mark, we stopped skating. We're not moving our feet right now. We look a little bit tired, and hopefully we can come on in the third period. Our forechecking is much better than it has been in the first previous two games. And if we can continue that, we're going to create some more chances, and hopefully we can get the one that wins the game.
John, you've started the season out with a very, very young team. Can you talk about some of the young players that have impressed you on this trip?
Well, I think Brown has really impressed me. He's playing well again tonight. He's had one or two chances and wasn't able to put the puck in the net. And McKee is another player that I think has really played well. I thought he played well in Calgary. He saw limited time in Calgary. He's seeing more time tonight. He's playing with Smelnik tonight, and he's getting more ice time. And he handles himself with a lot of poise. He moves the puck like a veteran. So we're looking forward to maybe Jay coming on, and maybe he'll make our hockey club before this season's all over. And Holzinger, I think, has had a fine game. I thought he skated real well in Calgary, and he's skating well again tonight, and he's really creative tonight, and he's had a couple of chances and hasn't been able to score. So we're quite happy with our young people and the enthusiasm of our hockey club. I think we're a little tentative in the first two games. I think we're uptight, and what this team has to do, they're young. They have to go out and enjoy themselves. They have to have fun and not really put a lot of pressure on them. There's a lot of other people around who put a lot of pressure on them, so they don't have to put pressure on themselves. So if they enjoy themselves, they're going to improve because they're skilled. They lack an experience, but they're really skilled youngsters.
All right. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll hope to go back with a win tonight. Absolutely. Buffalo Sabres hockey continues on the Empire Sports Network. The score after two periods, Sabres 1, Canucks 1. We'll be right back. Rick and Jim's analysis coming up next.
It's 4 for $5.55 time at Arby's. 4 beef and cheddars for just $5.55. Slow roasted beef and tangy cheddar cheese sauce on an onion roll. Times 4.
For Caravan, we invented new ways to stash your stuff. Now we're building more bins and boxes and a great new place to put them. the new Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises. We packed our full-size Ram with Magnum power. Now, we're reloading. The new Magnum-powered Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises.
Hi, this is Larry Playfair. Avoid traffic and confusion. Take the Metro Rail to the Sabres home opener, and between 4:30 and 6:30, meet members of the Buffalo Sabres alumni at the South Campus Station.
To really get inside the NFL, there's some equipment you'll need. Introducing Topps NFL Cyber Cards. All the action, all the plays, all the stats, all on a CD-ROM. Each Cyber Card features a different NFL star, and there's 28 different Cyber Cards to collect. So for the hardest hitting lift you've ever seen, it's Cyber Card. As close as you can get to the game without getting dirty.
To order with American Express, MasterCard, or Visa, call 1-800-341-7755 or send check or money order to the address on the screen.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jim Brinson of Fan TV. On Wednesday, while everybody else was talking fish, we were talking salmon.
Now, right now, he just signed about 5 minutes ago, past his physical.
And Howard Simon brought you the official word on Matt Stevens.
You getting ready to start on Sunday?
Yes, sir, right now. They told me in the morning.
And we help everybody put on their game face.
It says, what, game face on it?
On Thursday, Jets quarterback Frank Reich, right here on Fan TV. Your voice, your choice.
Buffalo trailing after one period of play in this hockey game, battling back early in the second, and it's all tied up 1-1 at GM Place after two. And the Sabres really took advantage of, I was going to call it the defensive lapse, but Leif Rolin let Jason Daw go, and then he caught up with him again, but Daw kind of fought off the check to score the goal.
It was really a great goal by Jason Daw all the way around, and a very bad decision by Leif Rolin at the Buffalo blue line. And here's how it begins, and you can see on the left of the screen is number 27 right here. This is Rolin right there. And watch what he does as the play comes up around the boards. He makes the wrong decision. Jason Daw, right here, chips the puck off the boards. And here the play begins. We stop it again. Now, if you want to watch these two players here, that's Daw and Rolin. And watch what Jason Daw does. And I've been talking about this all night as the Buffalo Sabres using their speed and quickness on the Vancouver defenseman. Daw just keeps skating. Rolin cannot control him. And Jason Daw ends up shooting the puck in off the goaltender, Kirk McLean. And that was a terrific goal, I thought, by the Buffalo Sabres, and an excellent play by Jason Daw.
And that's the only thing that you'll find on the Discover scoreboard. As a matter of fact, the only goal in the second period, Burridge and Wilson gaining the assists, and I'm sure Mike Wilson is absolutely delighted with that as he comes back to Vancouver from whence he was traded. Make the right decision, insist on Karuba collision. Hey, Al McGildy remembers Karuba as he nails Randy Burries right at, or I beg your pardon, it's Primo right at center ice. Primo bounced right back up again and got into the play, but I'm sure he felt that one just a little bit. And we are almost ready to resume action in period number three here at GM Place. This game is even at one on Empire.
News, views, stats, and checks. Football fan, Fred's your man. You want the scoop? Hang with Fred. Get in the loop. You know, get the inside scoop on DirecTV Pro Football Insider.
Old junky antique shops. I like.
You want me to tell you what my Discover card statement says?
Just little things that make a girl sing. I have fish, and I have birds, and I have dogs.
Mangoes.
Cecilia Bartoli and something by Puccini. Floridita Cuban restaurant. Fabulous. Stuck to my diet a little bit. That cash bonus thing at the end.
How many credit cards make a statement like that?
Yeah, a little.
It pays to Discover. Use it where you see the Nova sign.
Luxury car comfort. You said you wanted
style, and performance. You said you wanted something fun to drive. Well, now you can get all that plus a great deal. And guess what? It's a minivan, a Ford Windstar, actually. For a limited time, you can get $1,500 back on a new 96 Windstar, or choose a $279 a month red carpet lease. So what do you say now? Well, I say that this offer ends soon, so hurry to your local Ford dealer today.
It's four for $5.55 time at Arby's. Four beef and cheddars for just $5.55. Slow roasted beef and tangy cheddar cheese sauce on an onion roll. Times four.
Catch Fan Forum Mondays live at 5:30 on Empire Sports Network.
Sabres hockey is brought to you in part by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By Discover, it pays to discover. By McDonald's and their new deluxe line of sandwiches. Try one tomorrow. And by Tops Friendly Markets. Tops never stops saving you more.
23 shots on goal for the Vancouver Canucks so far in this hockey game, and most of them coming in the second period, 16-4 with the shots, even though the Sabres are the only goal.
Yeah, the scoring chances, 9-8 in favor of Vancouver. The Buffalo Sabres held the advantage in scoring chances after the first period of play, but they got a little ragged in the second, and the Canucks had some good scoring opportunities.
Mike Fountain. We mentioned him before, that he had signed. He had flown to Vancouver, signed on Monday, was assigned to Syracuse on Tuesday, flew there, and they flew him back into Vancouver today to serve as backup goaltender. This guy has gone back and forth across North America three times in 3 days. We talk about racking up frequent flyer. Maybe he'll be able to go to the moon.
And he'll be an expert on jet lag, too.
Here the Canucks keeping it in right off the bat. O'Coin gets tied up, but stuffs it down low. Zielina in the corner, bothered by Zipnik, leaves it to Linden. Linden trying to fight off Wanchek. It's kept in there to the Canucks again. That's shoveled away, and Galley will recover. Uses the glass, does not get it out. Vancouver keeping it in. Plant and Galley ran into each other. Now it's poked out to center ice, and Daw comes back with courage. Daw ripping it over the line, goes to his backhand in front as he ran into McLean, and Daw is going to get a penalty, and he's going to get a whole pile of O'Coin, who's on top of him.
What's he supposed to do in that play? Daw tried to cut to the front of the net, was being cut off by the defenseman, and then ran over top of Kirk McLean. That's what you call going to the net. Well, I disagree with that. I'm sure he's going to get a penalty, but what's he supposed to do? I think this is not a good call, but Kirk McLean, of course, got knocked over, and the rule states that the forwards are supposed to do or make every effort to avoid a collision with the goaltender. But here's Daw just getting into position, and there's nowhere to go except into the goaltender. And so Vancouver will go on the power play early here in the third, 47 seconds into the third period.
They'll call that every time, though, partner. They'll call that every time. Because they're bound and determined they're going to protect the goaltenders. Which I really don't have a big problem with. When goaltending is such a big part of, for instance, the Buffalo Sabres team.
Well, that's absolutely true. Jason Dodd, I'm sure, would wish the rule would be changed at this particular juncture. But boy, that was a good play, though, going back to the Sabre zone. It was Zipnik who started that play, back on defense for Buffalo, up to Daw. Ted Nolan's Hockey Club almost had their second of the night. So penalty killers, it's Pekka and Holzinger up front, and Schmelik and Shannon on defense.
Joseph sailed behind his own net, and Holzinger chased him back there. Now Chris Joseph. Flips it over on the wing to Quartnell, has to wait for the pass. Kicks it ahead, brought in over the line by Bure. Bure cutting for the net, and he shot it on the short side. Taking it, holding it in to Quartnell. To Joseph, back it comes to Quartnell. Picked it up off the glass, jammed to the corner, taken and let it go. Shannon takes it away, he's got time, but he can't get it out. Kept in by Joseph to Quartnell, and Quartnell did the job for Buffalo. He flipped it way wide of Lume. Lume after it. Pekka after him. Knocked his hat off. Jam at center ice.
Pekka tried to pick it free, does, and taps it in. He doesn't have far to go to step off the ice for a rest, and does. Tiekkanen. We'll wheel it back now for the Canucks to Kortno. Back to Tiekkanen again. And he's covered by Brown. Taken away by Wilson. Wilson flipping it. And Brown just very coolly sent it through center ice. Less than a minute remaining in the penalty. Lume still hapless. He's guiding it up on the wing to Bure. Bure tipping it across for Joseph again. Joseph rings it behind the net. Hasek traps it to Galley. He flings it around on the boards, but not up. Lume keeping it in. Galley will get another try. Shovels it to the other side. Lafontaine catching up with the puck, kicking at it. Sending it to center ice. And Brown will tap it down the ice and head off for a rest with 20 seconds left in the power play. Up to Linden at center. Linden squeezed out and knocked down by McKee. McKee can't get the puck. Jelena has it. Jelena stuffing it into Trevor Linden in the corner. McKee cut him off at the pass. They fight for it behind the net. It comes free to Bure. Bure sliding it back. The coin-blown shot. That goes wide. Hooked around on the boards again. Not out. Sabres return to full strength. It's whipped across ice for Bure. Pekka flipped it. He didn't get it out. Jelena keeping it in front of the net. Hasek knocked it away. The rebound just goes wide. McKee tied up by Linden as they go to the boards together. McKee fighting to tie it up, trying to get a face-off in there. Can't do it. Canucks take it away, but now Schmelik drills it off the boards and whistles it down the ice, and this will prompt the officials to call an icing call here a little over 3 minutes into the third period. 1-1 on Empire.
You cheating heart will make you weep. You'll cry and cry and try to sleep. But sleep won't come. Your cheating heart will tell on you.
For Caravan, we invented new ways to stash your stuff. Now we're building more bins and boxes, and a great new place to put them. The new Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises. We packed our full-size Ram with Magnum Power. Now, we're reloading. The new Magnum Power Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises.
The Sabres successfully kill off the penalty to Vancouver, and the Canucks, although they were in the Buffalo zone for quite a period of time, did not manage a shot on goal.
Here's Shannon. He stumbles behind the net. Was after it again. Ojic knocked it away. Gino Ojic keeping it in there. Flips it back into Ridley. He took a bump on the wall but holds it in. That's cleared across ice. Ojic going after it. Ojic. Wilson picks up his check along the boards. Doesn't get it out. Rolin keeping it in. Kortno. He gets knocked down. Rolin flipped it again. Ojic has it once again for Vancouver. Trying to clear it in front. It goes to an open wing. Daw is there first. He fanned on it. And Plant just got rid of it through center. Too far for Burridge. Joseph. Now for the Canucks. Deals it around on the boards. Sabres Plant flips it back to the point. Galley missed it. It came out over the line. And this will result in an offside against Buffalo. 4 minutes have gone by here in the third period.
Now, Gary Galley was talking to me this morning about trying to defense Pavel Bure and Alexander Mogilny, and he said, you know, both players are a lot like Brett Hull in the sense that you don't notice them, and all of a sudden there they are picking up a loose puck or going into an open area of ice for a breakaway. And Galley said, what I try to do with Mogilny and Bure, he says, is try to, every time I get an opportunity, to bump them off the puck, bump them into the boards, just try to distract them. And so far the Sabres have done a good job against the two of them tonight, although Bure did score in the opening 14 seconds of play, but that's all they've been able to, that's all Buffalo have given up.
Well, it's picked up at center ice by Ward. Ward works his way to the Vancouver line. He gets checked. Ray helps him out. Ray kicks it all the way back for Zitnik.
See, there's a play there. Dixon Warden has to get the puck in deep, particularly when the Sabres have been successful at pursuing the Vancouver defense.
Yali swings it to Ray. Cullimore kept it in. Now it's chipped out to center ice. A chance for Pekka. He's got a breakaway. Pekka in on goal. Backhand. He shot it wide. Picked up by Gure in the corner. Gure rips it around on the glass. Jelena will leave it there. Lume coming back with Gure. Pass it over the line to Linden. Linden gets taken down by Ray. Pekka picks it up. After failing with the breakaway. Pass to Zhitnik at center. That's stolen away. O'Coin wheels it over to Babich. Babich clears it back to Bure. It was in his skates. Jelena taps it in over the line. That's knocked down in front of the net. Sabres get an opportunity to Ward. He'll swing it up ahead, but it went behind Holzinger. Now to Bure again. In it goes to Jelena. Jelena looking in front. Yali got a piece of him. Jelena carries on in the corner. Jelena still with the puck. Taken away by Schmelik. Schmelik starts out. LaFontaine got grabbed by Jelena. The pass for Holzinger too far. McLean way out of the net. In behind the goal. Holzinger couldn't get it out. In front. Came in front of the net. Rebound. LaFontaine. They score. Finally slammed into the net after a wild scramble around the net. Holzinger, I believe, was the one who hooked it into the goal. And the Buffalo Sabres, after being down very early in this game, now have the lead 2-1.
The speed of Buffalo, we've been talking about that all night, to try to take advantage of the slow Vancouver defense, and here it is. McLean makes a bad play behind the net, Buffalo all over the loose puck, and Brian Holzinger right here with the quick backhand shot beats Kirk McLean, who is out of position along with the Vancouver defense. So the speed and quickness of Buffalo creates another goal.
McPhee tips it through center ice now, and that one will be handled by the goaltender to Babich. He rolls it around to the boards. McGillney didn't get it out. Brown keeping it in. Playing forced to play it once again. It's whipped up on the wing to McGillney to Tikkanen. Tikkanen lands up the long shot. It's way wide of the net. Tikkanen hustles after it. Schmelik's all over him. Worked to Holzinger, the goal getter. He flipped it and hit the referee. Canucks will keep it in. Hasek helping out his teammates. He tees it up to Schmelik. Schmelik's pass at center is recovered by the Canucks. Now it's flipped back through the middle and taken away. Now fired in by Tikkanen. Tikkanen ripping it around on the boards again. They jam it back into the corner. And the Canucks going down. They're still fighting for it. Sillinger still has it in his skates. Vancouver's turn to keep the pressure on. Hasek will leave it back there. Taken away and cleared off the glass. This one dribbles its way inside the Vancouver line. Joseph back to pick it up. Both teams are changing. Long pass. Tikkanen hacks it in and heads to the bench. Hasek lost it. Came in front of the net. And it's recovered by Wilson working it to Daw. Cross ice now to Burridge. Burridge slapping at it. Couldn't get there. Platt leaves it to the blue line. That's broken up. Canucks coming away. And over the line is Ojic. He took a shot that deflects wide of the net. And Hasek will just flop on that one and hang on long enough for a face-off. A little over 7 minutes have gone by here in the third period, and Buffalo has the lead for the first time on Empire.
And now, from Paris, from Milan, from St. Louis,
introducing a new look from Budweiser. Born on dating. It's the day your bud was born, because fresh beer tastes better.
Nice label.
Thanks.
Lots and lots, tons and tons of tennis balls. Some of the things that are on my Discover card statement. I travel quite a bit. Ooh, I didn't know that the golf balls were out here. Just relax, enjoy nature, and very good. Labidochromis coeruleus. They don't want to play with me now because I beat them 90% of the time. I'll take out $100 to buy the bait, gas up the boat.
How many credit cards make a statement like that?
See, what else do I have on
it
this?
It pays to Discover. Use it where you see the Nova sign.
Getting ready for the faceoff coming up in the Buffalo end. As Brian Holzinger scored from Schmelik and Brown to put Buffalo in front. Lume in behind the Sabres net, out in front, backhand into goal, 3-6 ball, still jamming away at it. And it's held along the line as Dominic Hasek covering up every little bit of territory that he possibly could to make the save.
Vancouver can thank Gino Ojek for that opportunity as he got in front of the Buffalo net. That's number 29, Ojek. He's standing right in front of Dominik Hasek. And watch what the big guy does as Lume comes around behind the net. And of course, anytime you can fall on a goaltender like that, when somebody pushes you, you take full advantage of it and you stay there. You just stay on top of the goaltender, try to take him out of the play, but Hasek does recover and come up with a puck.
Puck will now to keep it in, firing a shot right on. Hasek to save. Puck will clear it in front again. And it's jammed just wide of the net. And that's putting on some pressure. Cullimore moves up on the play. The pass is deflected through center ice by Burridge. Now dumped in the other direction. Plant trying to get away at the blue line for Daw. Daw poked at it. Ojek takes it back. To Lume. Lume works it ahead to Ridley. He just taps it out to center. That's recovered by Shannon. Leaving it there and over the line to Daw. Faked his shot. Left it there to Burridge. It's shot right on. McLean boots it away. Rolled behind the net. Daw couldn't pick it up. Right around on the boards. Plant keeping it in. Tucking it back into Burridge again. Burridge in front, didn't get it to Daw. Daw after it again behind the goal. Around to Burridge. Burridge slapping out of the corner, gets tied up. Here's Daw with the puck. Daw fighting off a check of Ridley. And Ridley comes up with the puck, getting it to Burre. Burre trying to get away as he comes to center ice. Burre really dangling now. In over the Buffalo line. Cookie shot, ripped it wide. Left around on the board, slapped ahead, and ends up back at center ice. Babich recovering. He fired it across ice. Bure knocked it free. Ward couldn't get anywhere. Shannon. Zhitnik uses the boards to find Ray. Ray will guide one around behind the net. Ward hustling in there after it. But he failed to connect. Ray came across ice. Missed Jelena. Bure starts back again. Bure into Buffalo territory. Leaving it to Jelena. Jelena works it into the corner. Got it in front. And a shot by Ridley goes off the glass. Ray picks it up in the corner. He'll get it up to Ward at center ice. Ward gains the red line, now flips it in as his teammates begin making changes. Back comes Rolin, slipping it up ahead. It's poked out to center again, but Schmelik will sail it right back in for Buffalo with 10.5 to go here in the third period. Holzinger in to do some forechecking, but cannot come up with his check, and it's poked ahead by Joseph to center ice. McKee takes it back and gives it to LaFontaine. Across to Schmelik. Schmelik for LaFontaine at center. Taps it into the corner. Brown hustling in there. Brown behind the net. It's squeezed out on the wall and taken down by Kekkonen. Came to the blue line. McKee got it back to LaFontaine. Cross ice and whipped in again by Holzinger. What's left in behind the net? Halfway through the third period, 2-1 Buffalo. Sent off the boards as far as center ice, but it hit a skate. And the Canucks recovering to Joseph. Joseph challenged by LaFontaine to Sellinger. Sellinger cranking it across ice. Rolin whips it to Tikkanen. He fired it back through the middle again. It's brought to the blue line and over. Comes into Mogilny. Mogilny cutting right in the shot. Hasek makes the save. Hope back along the boards again. Schmelik fell. It's tip free. And the Sabres will get an opportunity to get it out, but Richard Schmelik is down on the ice. He has been injured. And Jim Pizzatelli comes darting off the Buffalo bench to take a look at number 42.
Now, Schmelik was involved in the corner with one of the Canucks, but watch this great chance by Mogilny on the quick move and the save, or the puck hit Schmelik in the ankle.
That's why he's down.
And that's good news because it's not his knee. I thought Hasek initially stopped it, but he did not. That puck hit Richard Schmelik in the right ankle. And Richard is making his way to the bench, so...
He probably doesn't think it's good news, huh? Well, it's new and it's exciting. Fan TV, weeknights, 4:30 to 7. You can count on Jim Brinson and Howard Simon to keep you up to date on the Sabres, Bills, and regional sports, and a whole lot more. Your choice, your voice, Fan TV, exclusively on the Empire Sports Network.
The face-off to the left of Hasek. Holzinger gave Buffalo the lead earlier in the third period. Jason Daw up front along with Burridge. Alex Mogilny had a couple of good chances tonight. Dominik Hasek stopped him a couple of times, and most recently was Richard Schmelik.
Canucks keeping it in, though, on the faceoff. Went wide of the net. Shannon got it as far as the blue line. Not out. Now Plant will dart away with it. Plant sailing in over the line. Took his shot. McLean to save the rebound. And McLean covers up on Plant's rebound. And Brewery's got hammered beside the net by Olczyk. Sabres are claiming there should be a penalty here that came after the play, but no penalty was indicated by the referee, McCreary.
Well, we've been talking all evening about the Buffalo speed, and I want to show you something. This is Derek Plant, who picks up the puck, and watch what the Vancouver defense does. We can roll it from there, guys. This is speed, and if we can stop it right here, look at the two defensemen and where they are for the Vancouver Canucks. How far they back in. They allow Derek Plant the blue line. And watch what Plant does. Not only does he get this shot away, he uses his quickness to go around Courtnell and get another scoring chance.
And then Burridge got punched right in the coconut, and no penalty was called there on Gino Ogic. LaFontaine out on the draw for Buffalo. Back it comes to Shannon. Took a shot. McLean the save. Audette had his stick held by Rolin. Canucks with a chance around to Zelina. Zelina doesn't get it out, though. Now it's finally whipped to center up to Bure. Bure in over the line. Wilson stays with him. Backhand goes wide. Get around to the boards. Rolin keeping it into Bure, and it's taken away by Groshek. Groshek to LaFontaine. Got away from him. In fact, he couldn't even pick it off because it was too high. And as a result, the Sabres are going to find themselves cold on an icing. Less than nine to go here in the third.
For Caravan, we invented new ways to stash your stuff. Now we're building more bins and boxes and a great new place to put them. The new Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises. We packed our full-size Ram with Magnum Power. Now we're reloading. The new Magnum Power Dodge Dakota. It's full of surprises.
It's four for $5.55 time at Arby's. Four beef and cheddars for just $5.55. Slow roasted beef and tangy cheddar cheese sauce on an onion roll. Times four.
Hi, this is Larry Playfair. Avoid traffic and confusion. Take the Metro Rail to the Sabres home opener, and between 4:30 and 6:30, meet members of the Buffalo Sabres alumni at the South Campus Station.
Fire-breathing Buffalo is going to be on Marine Midland Ice on Saturday night against the Detroit Red Wings. The long shot fired wide of the net. Hooked around on the boards. It goes to center ice. Sabres trying to get away. Here is Groshek in over the line. But he got hooked down by Joseph. There's no penalty called. Groshek ends up on top of the puck in the corner. Still fighting for it there. Groshek is still on top of it on his knees. Joseph's on top of him. Not free by the Canucks. Cleared up on the wing. Out to center. Zelina to Bure. He'll just tap it in. That goes to the corner. Zelina after it. Zitnik on him. Canucks keeping it in to Linden. Linden cruising around back at the point. He fires it down low. Here's Zitnik trying to come up with it. Came out in front of the net, and the Sabres recovering, and Galley swings it off the board through center ice. Buffalo making another change. Rolin just stuffs it up on the wing, and this is way offside against Vancouver as Bure was deep in Buffalo territory and was all tangled up with Galley. He couldn't get out.
Now, good news for Buffalo. Richard Schmelik is okay. He's just stepped onto the ice after being injured by that shot from Alexander Mogilny. There's Richard. And I talked to Richard this morning. He said he's really had no problem, of course, recovering from that knee. He has been consistent and had a great game on this road trip in Edmonton. He was voted a star of that game, and I thought he was the best player on the ice. Well, that Buffalo defense, when you look at it, you know, Schmelik, of course, is out there with Jay McKee, who's taking a regular shift here in the third period as Ted Nolan is showing great confidence in the rookie McKee.
The Canucks knocking it in over the Buffalo line, but Pekka steals it back. Pekka feeding it through the middle to Ray. He'll chip one in. It's covered up back there, and McCoy waiting for it. Less than 8 minutes left on the clock here in the third period. GM Place in Vancouver. Pass through the middle to Tikkanen. And keeping his poise was McKee to break it up. Ward lost it. Hasek tapping it behind the net to Schmelik. Rings it on the boards, but O'Coin keeps it in. Mogilny then sails it across ice. Tikkanen holding it in with a shot that gets knocked down in front of the net. Sabres with Pekka forcing it out to center, bothered by Sillinger from behind. Mogilny stepping back in over the line. He darts into the corner and fired it across to the other side. Ray can't get it. Canucks keeping it in there. Down to Mogilny. Mogilny working down low. Now comes back out in front, going to his forehand to Tikkanen. Tikkanen winds up. Screenshot. Hasek to save. Rebound is knocked away. And Pekka gives it to Ward. He fires it out to center ice. Canucks recovering. Less than 7 minutes to go to Babich again. Babich will send it back in as he's bumped by McKee. Schmelik drills it off the glass. This one will make it down the ice. And it will come back on an icing as the Sabres were looking to make a line change. And so were the Canucks. And now Brown and Olczyk are mixing it up. And Olczyk went after Brown at center ice.
Eugenio Olczyk, one of the heavyweights on the Vancouver Canucks, along with Corey Crowder. And it was Olczyk who went to management and asked them to sign Troy Crowder. He said, you can always use two tough guys on the same team. And Olczyk is an Algonquin Indian who does a great deal of work with the Native American youth, and he's still...
Oh, we've got everybody now. Ray is out there as well, and Ray is trying to get in front of Olczyk, and I think he's telling the official, wait a minute, this guy wants to go, I'm the guy who will go with them, not Curtis Brown.
I think Gino got away with a little bit there. Not going to be any penalties called.
Olczyk is seeing a lot of ice time here in the third. He's had a strong game for Vancouver, particularly, of course, around that Buffalo net, harassing the goaltender. But Olczyk, 6'4", 225 pounds. And I was mentioning, he does a lot of work with the Native Americans. There's a hockey school that he runs every summer and just does a lot of work in the drug and alcohol abuse department.
You mentioned Troy Crowder. Crowder has not played any more than a couple of shifts in this hockey game. He's not been up there. And as a matter of fact, Alexander Semak, I don't think, has been on the ice here in the third period. There's a chance for Wilson. He gets knocked down in the corner. Olczyk trying to dig it free, but the puck is underneath Mike Wilson, and they'll drop it again with 6.5 minutes left on the clock. Buffalo Sabres and Sabres single game seats on sale. Try and say that one in a hurry, folks, at this time of night. Available at all fantastic outlets in Topps Friendly Markets and at the Sabres ticket office. LaFontaine winning the draw from Ridley. Wilson in the corner, going to work it along the wall, does to center ice, Holzinger coming in over the line, back to Brown, shoots one. Oh, and he ripped it high and wide on the short side. Olczyk comes out to center now. He tips it through the middle, in over the line, a chance for Cortino firing it in for the backhand. Looks out of the net as Ridley tapped it wide. LaFontaine darts in there. Oh, it's taken away by Buffalo, but they can't get it out. Tipped in by the Canucks. Olczyk after it again. Swings it back to Cullimore. His shot hit a leg. Brown merging after Ridley. They go to the boards together. Lume keeping it in there. Lume leaving it to Olczyk once more. He fired it right on. There's the rebound. Hasek makes the save. Hooked in behind the net. Wilson takes it away. Wilson sending it to center ice. Lume knocks it down. Buffalo trying to change. Canucks coming right back again. Lume got a trace. Going right in with the goal post. Lume fired that one off the post. Right around on the boards. Not out. Vancouver putting the pressure on here in the third. Shipnick got it out through center ice. Cullimore couldn't catch up with it. Joseph does. Joseph slipping back behind his own net. To give it to the captain, Linden. Linden lost it. Daw fires it and rips it wide of the net. Round on the boards. Held in by Galley. Poking it back in for Burridge. He leaves it to Daw. Daw slapping it behind the net. Linden going after it. Platt trying to get him. Taken away by Bure. Bure starts up now as he comes through center ice. Hits the Buffalo line. The long shot off the glass. Hasek collects it off the backboards. Started to play it away, but the whistle had already gone.
Dominic Hasek under intense pressure here in the third period has really settled down. I go back to John Muckler was talking to Dennis Williams in the second intermission. John said he was a little shaky at the beginning, but certainly regained his composure in the second.
2-1, Buffalo in the lead on Empire.
freshness hotline. What's the problem?
Man, my party is lame. I think I got some skunky beer.
Sir, relax. When was your beer born?
Born? What are you talking about?
It doesn't have a born-on date?
A what?
Do you have any Budweiser?
No, man, you gotta help me.
Okay, remain calm, sir. We're on our way.
New Born on Dating from Budweiser, because fresh beer tastes better.
Go, 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 go!
Sir, put down the skunky beer and slowly back away.
If you've been thinking about pursuing a career in sports or upgrading your current education for promotion, or maybe you've been thinking about a career change, then you should think about the Masters of Science in Sport Administration program at Canisius College. One of only four programs of its kind in the country, the Sport Administration program has formed affiliations with major professional sports organizations across the country. And with our highly experienced and qualified faculty, the Masters of Science in Sport Administration at Canisius College is the one program in Western New York for you. Call now for more information.
Face-off coming up in the Buffalo end.
You know, in face-offs in this third period, there have been 12. Vancouver have won 9 of them.
Ouch. 5 minutes left on the clock. Zitnik trying to work it around on the boards. Does to the corner. Daw being challenged in there as he collides with Rolene. Rolene down on the ice. It comes free to Sillinger with a shot. And she had to hold the post. McGillney kicks it free. Doesn't get it out, though. Now he kicks it in again to Sillinger. Sillinger still with the puck. In front. Taken in shot. Didn't get through. Burridge trying to work it out of there. Burridge shovels it out as far as center ice. Taken and takes it back. The Sabres certainly look tired here in the third period. And knocked ahead. That's knocked down. Buffalo coming back with Flat. Flat to the Canuck line. He'll tap it in. Gets turned around and taken down by Tikkanen. And now Flat up to his feet and hustles to the bench. Vancouver's turn to come right back again to Linden. Linden ripping in with a shot right on. Hasek the save. Goes behind the net. McKee trying to take out Linden. There's a shot by Bure. Handled by Hasek. Hasek out of the net. Linden a little too close, so he'll hang on and call another face-off as we take a look around the National Hockey League and other games being played and have been played tonight. The Islanders in Ottawa all knotted up at 3. Montreal, not too much difficulty with Los Angeles. Detroit flanking the Edmonton Oilers 2-0. The Oilers' first loss. Anaheim did in the Blackhawks in Chicago, and St. Louis over Calgary 3-1. This is the only game still underway in the NHL tonight. And it has 4 minutes remaining in the third period with Buffalo up by 1. Fontaine winning that draw to McKee. He chops it around on the boards, but Lume kept it in at the point. Here's Hasek kicking it into the corner right onto Bure's stick. Bure drops it off to Lume again. Lume running the goal crease. Oh! Hasek just robbed Bure. Bure throws his arms up. He cannot believe it. Dominic Hasek robbed him blind.
Now that picture tells 1,000 words. Pavel Bure thought he had Hasek beaten. So did everyone in this building. Let's just watch Dominic on this play. Unbelievable. If you can't stop it one way, folks, you stop it another, and there it is, unbelievable. Bure thinks the puck is in the net. He cannot believe it. And Hasek, who has starred here tonight, stops another one.
Trying to take advantage of what clearly is a very tired Buffalo Sabres hockey team at this point in time. Plant and Linden. It's tipped into the corner. Shannon tying up his check, but the Canucks keep it in. There came right beside the net again. Not out. Linden holding it in. To Bure once more. Bure trying to drop it off. That's broken up. Shot goes wide of the net. Hasek. Bothered by Jelena, got it around on the boards, but not out. Canucks holding it in with Lume. He's at the Jelena, tried to get it in front. Wilson broke it up. Kept in there to Linden. Linden curling around to Lume in the corner. Back it goes to Linden. The long shot. That deflects and Hasek makes the save as McGillney tried to gain position on Shannon. Or Bure, I beg your pardon.
I think this might be an opportunity for Buffalo to call a timeout. They are running all over their own zone, and that last play you had Mike Wilson, who was a defenseman, covering the point man, and that just should not happen. As Randy Burridge moved in
deep in the zone. Mike Wilson, that's number four, that's Wilson. Out in front of the net, or up by the point man, and Hashik covers up quickly. And Buffalo, in this situation, this is where the veterans come into play. They've got to slow it down. Give Hashik time to recover. Give Ted Nolan a chance to get the players that he wants on the ice. So you got to waste some time. Give your club a chance to get a breather.
Way to center ice. Brown, he tips it up ahead, but lost the glove. Has to gain that back again. Joseph picks it up. 3 minutes left on the clock here in the third period. Holzinger trying to steal it in the corner. Can't do it. Joseph starts away. Joseph fires it to Courtnell. Cross ice pass broken up at center, but Joseph carries on. Joseph flipping one in. Ends up behind the net. Hashik got it back in the other direction. Brown trying to tie it up on the boards. Can't do it. Goes after it again. Rolls in behind the net. Kept in there by the Canucks. They really had the pressure on. O'Coin with the long shot. Here's the rebound. Swept in front, backhand by Olczyk. That's taken away. And Holzinger now coming to center, looking for Lapointeno. He didn't give it to him. Holzinger carries on, in over the line. Going right in, go backhand, and he shot it wide. O'Coin comes up with it for Vancouver. He brings it to center ice. Broken up by Shannon, but he lost it. Comes in with Sillinger. There's the shot. Hashik kicked that away. O'Coin trying to keep it in there. Knocked free, and Ward will try and gain center, and now does, and taps it down the ice. 2 minutes left on the clock here in the third. Taking it to Babich. Babich chopped it to the blue line and up to center. Ends up on top of the puck, and he'll pin it right there. 1:54 remaining.
Boy, Vancouver, desperate hockey here in the third, cannot beat Dominic Hasek. Hasek has a total of 35 shots on goal, 34 saves. The only goal that beat him was the first shot of the hockey game. That's 14 it. Seconds into it, Bure scored. And the Canucks have done everything you can ask from a hockey club offensively here in the third except score.
Discover Card is a proud contributor to the Make-A-Wish Foundation. And tonight we'll make a donation on behalf of the Empire Sports Network and the Buffalo Sabres. They are now, well, the Canuck players are talking to their goaltender, Kirk McLean. I think they're trying to make a decision as to when he might come out of the net. A little too much time yet. 1:54 left on the clock. But no doubt, here in the third period, Dominic Hasek has been the difference big time. Plant on his knees, trying to tip it ahead. In over the line, Burridge chopped at it, couldn't get it. Lume brings it back. Lume will flip it to the Buffalo line. That's knocked down. McGillney being bothered at center ice, fighting off a check. He flips it into the corner. Hasek coming out of the net. Worked it around on the glass. Babich took a shot. That one hit Plant. Daw couldn't get it out. Now Daw goes after it again. Daw just tapping it through center ice. Lume charging back after it. 1:25 left on the clock. Lume checked in the corner. Rivers trying to keep the pressure on by knocking it back into Burridge. He'll leave it there to Plant. Plant twisting and turning, couldn't control it. Lume takes it away, but Burridge is on him. Now Babich comes up with the puck, and Kekkonen got away with a penalty at center ice on Shannon. Daw picks it off. Daw will flip it in. And both teams do some changing. 1 minute remaining in the third period. Kekkonen tapped it away to center. Galley couldn't get it, and it's called a two-line pass on the upside. And Kekkonen is really upset.
Now, Tikkanen's claiming that Buffalo touched the puck in the neutral zone, but the linesmen are saying, no, the puck bounced over the Sabres stick to Pavel Bure. 57.7 seconds remaining, and Tikkanen, who always has something to say, talked to Essa the other morning, too, after practice. He wanted to know how Doug Moss was. Of course, he knew Doug from, or when they were both associated with the New York Ranger Association. He says, well, be sure to say hello to him.
Partner, this may be one of the fastest hockey games I have ever been involved with. This is less than 2 hours old, this game, and we have less than a minute remaining. I don't know exactly when it started, but I know it was certainly after 7:33, and it's 9:33 now.
Now, here's where the strategy comes in. Tom Rennie trying to talk calmly to his troops. Ted Nolan on the other side, of course. I'm really not saying too much, just allowing the Sabres to talk among themselves. But the faceoff will be in the neutral zone, and I'm sure that Tom Rennie will try to set up a play off the faceoff. The decision, do you pull your goalie now, or do you wait until the puck is dropped and then pull him to see
And let me apologize too, partner. It's not less than 2 hours. This was a 7:08 game. It was not 7:38. That's what I was thinking of. Still, it's been a quick game. Yeah, still. Yes, I eat my words.
So Kirk McLean will go back in the net for Vancouver. LaFontaine, Burridge, Daw up front, along with Schmelik and Galley. So the veteran Galley and Schmelik on defense. Now LaFontaine has a decision here too. Does he attempt to go ahead with the puck, or does he try to pull it back to his defense? Dominated, shots on goal by Vancouver, but they have scored only one time.
And Buffalo has one in the second and one here in the third. Again, it's the 16s in the faceoff area. It's tapped back to Joseph. Joseph sliding it to Jelena. Jelena is denied by Burridge. Jelena must curl back. Over to Joseph on the other side. 45 seconds to go as LaFontaine does some forechecking. It's just fired through center ice and down the ice. No icing. Hasek's going to tee it up for Schmelik. Schmelik going behind the net. Cleared it. Off Burridge's leg and back into Vancouver territory as the Canucks have pulled their goaltender. McLean is on the bench in favor of an extra attacker. 25 seconds to go ahead. It goes to McGillney. McGillney to the Buffalo line and over. Leaves it to Bure. Back to McGillney. Tried to clear it in front. Rolled in behind the net. Linden got tied up. Here's McGillney. Got it out in front and Bure failed to connect. Vancouver keeping it in there. 10 seconds to go. Came in front again. He shot knocked down by Daw. And it's cleared out to center ice by Burridge. Recovered by Lume, but he has to wait for his teammates to get onside. And the Buffalo Sabres have won their first game of the year, wrapping up their three-game Western Canadian road swing with a 2-1 come-from-behind win here at GM Place.
And rightly so, the first player that is mobbed is Dominik Hasek. An incredible performance again by Hasek here tonight. And what a play Jason Daw made in the closing seconds of the game. With no stick, he blocked the point-blank shot, and the Sabres win it by a score of 2-1 here in Vancouver.
And there is absolutely no doubt whatsoever in anybody's mind in this building as to who would be the number one star in this hockey game. As the Sabres battle back from giving up a goal only 14 seconds into the game, to skate off the ice with a 2-1 win.
Here's the play I was talking about as Daw blocked the shot with the left skate. Buffalo clears the zone. The game is over.
So the Sabres takes them three tries in Western Canada, but they come out and they head back home with a victory under their belts on Empire.
See your local Jeep and Eagle dealer. Television stations need you. Medical companies need you. Computer companies need you. If you know electronics, top companies need you today. To develop the electronic skills employers are looking for, call ITT Technical Institute at 1-800-823-6315 for an informative brochure. That's 1-800-823-6315. But call now. Because aeronautics companies need you. Automobile companies need you. Robotics companies need you.
Hey, come here. You, come here. You want to play fantasy football with the pros? Then watch Fantasy Football Weekly.
Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly delivers the inside scoop. Our experts focus on every facet of football, analyzing key weekly matchups, injury reports, and sleepers.
Playoff Fantasy Football Weekly. Don't miss it.
Welcome back to GM Place. The final score from Vancouver, Buffalo beats the Canucks by a final score of 2-1. I am joined now by the guy who scored the game winner in this one, Brian Holzinger, and it was a little bit iffy there going down the stretch. We weren't sure if your goal was going to be the game winner, but Dominic was unbelievable.
Yeah, he was. He made a great save at the end there on Bure, and you know, that's what it takes, some saves like that and some good play from everybody on the team to win hockey games, and that's the way we're going to win hockey games this year, and we realize that.
You guys were forechecking so much better tonight and crashing the net, and your goal was a result of that.
Yeah, that's something we talked about. You know, we feel with our team speed and quickness, we should be able to get in there and force their defense to turn over the puck, and that's something that we really didn't do too well in the first two games, and something we wanted to take care of tonight, and we did, and it paid off for us.
Great, Brian. We're going to take a look at that goal right now, and you can tell us exactly how the play developed and what happened.
Well, I knew he was going to go behind the net here. I actually wanted to turn around and stuff it, but that D kind of got to me pretty quick, and then Brownie tried to get it out front to Schmelly, and the rebound was right there, and you know, luckily for me, that defenseman took Patty and, you know, kind of left the puck there. So, you know, it was just kind of a forechecking goal by Curtis Brown, and great play by him, and, you know, fortunately it paid off for me.
Great. Brian, is this season sort of starting off like a storybook for you? You score the first goal ever in the Marine Midland Arena, and then you score the game winner for the first win of the season.
Oh, yeah. The first goal in the Marine Midland was certainly something I always remember, and this one is probably one of my biggest goals of my career, and, you know, hopefully there's a lot more to come, and, you know, I'll take them when they come.
A little easier to go home now and open in the new building now that you got a win under your belt?
Yeah, there's no question. You know, we were kind of pressing ourselves here a little bit. We thought we played okay in the first two games, but, you know, not well enough to win the hockey game. And, you know, tonight we played well enough to win, and we did win.
All right, Brian, thanks. It'll be a nice trip back now, a lot better. The Sabres get their first win of the season here in Vancouver. They beat the Canucks by a final score of 2-1. Rick and Jim will wrap this thing up when we come back.
Lots and lots, tons and tons of tennis balls. Some of the things that are on my Discover card statement. I travel quite a bit. Ooh, I didn't know that the golf balls were out here. Just relax, enjoy nature, and very good. Labidochromis coeruleus. They don't want to play with me now because I beat them 90% of the time. I'll take out $100 to buy the bait, gas up the boat.
How many credit cards make a statement like that?
See, what else do I have on
it
this?
It pays to Discover. Use it where you see the Nova sign.
Your cheating heart will make you weep. You'll cry and cry and try to sleep, but sleep won't come. Your cheating heart will tell on you.
As a result of that score, the Buffalo Sabres have chalked up their first victory of this very young National Hockey League season. And again, as has happened so often in the past, who did it? Oh, it's Dominic did it again.
Oh, he had a tremendous night after a shaky start.
Yeah,
Bure scored 14 seconds into the game. But Dominic, the veteran, as John Muckler was saying to Dennis Williams, back in the intermission, he's a great competitor, and he got a hold of himself, got a hold of his game, and it seems the more shots he gets, the better he becomes, and there was no shortage of shots tonight from the second period on.
Well, and in the last 10 minutes of the game, yeah, Dominic was about the only Buffalo Sabre who wasn't back on his heels.
Well, that's right, and he was as strong as ever in here, and here's just an example of what Dominic was doing all evening, and only stopping the puck, but quickly jumping on the rebound, and then how about this save on Pavel Bure? Watch what Hasek does. He just seems to know that what he has to do to make the save. Watch him throw his arms back while he's on his back and rob Pavel Bure, who absolutely could not believe that the puck did not cross the goal line. He was absolutely flabbergasted.
Well, he put his arms up in the air. He thought it was in the net. He said, there's no way this guy could have stopped it.
He thought it was in without question, but Hasek, of course, stopped Bure a number of times tonight along with Alexander Mogilny.
Well, the Canucks end up getting a few extra as far as chances are concerned and a lot extra as far as shots on goal are concerned, 35-19, but they don't get the 2 points. The Buffalo Sabres do, and they head back home with their first 2 points of this National Hockey League season. And the next stop for Buffalo will be at the Marine Midland Arena. Their first official game, regular season game, to be played in the building Saturday night at 7:30 on Empire and on Channel 4. Good night from Vancouver.